restaurants. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyMeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, a Jacoby, Massachusetts man is facing charges after posting "Put Wings on Pigs" to Facebook, according to police. Charlie DeRosa will be summoned to court for threat to commit a crime. Police will file a complaint in court seeking a show cause hearing. If the court determines the complaint is valid, a trial will be scheduled. On Saturday, two New York police officers were killed by a gunman while sitting in their police cruiser. The suspect, who then killed himself, had posted, "I'm putting wings on pigs today," on social media. Jacoby police posted on their Facebook page that the alleged threat by DeRosa was taken seriously because of the events of the past few days. The Interview was put back into theaters Tuesday when Sony Pictures Entertainment announced a limited Christmas Day theatrical release for the comedy that provoked an international incident with North Korea and outrage over its canceled release. Sony Entertainment CEO Michael Lynton said the James Franco, Seth Rogen, North Korea farce will be in a number of theaters beginning on Thursday. He said Sony is also continuing its efforts to release the film on more platforms and in more theaters. Today's broadcast of the Liberty Beat is made possible by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. Support for the Liberty Beat also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, December 24th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On December 6th, over 600 citizens marched in Boulder, Colorado, demanding that police stop shooting and killing unarmed African Americans. The protest came in response to the shooting in Ferguson, Missouri, and many others like it that have happened around the country. But who organized the protest? It was a full-time activist who had a financial backer, Alexis Neely. Without Neely, he would have not been able to dedicate 60 to 80 hours a week to organizing. Because of Neely's sponsorship, he could focus on activism. Neely believes in putting her money where her heart is. And for her, that means sponsoring people doing good in the world. Now, Neely is using business to help people put their money where their heart is. Right now, Neely is offering a free training to those who want to get in the right relationship with money and use it to make the world a better place. Her free training is available right now online at moneymap.tv. For as often as Democrats attack the conservative billionaires Charles and David Koch for their heavy spending on politics, it's actually the liberal-minded who shelled out the most cash on the just-completed midterm elections. At least that is among those groups that must disclose what they raise and spend. That word comes in a special report from the Associated Press. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your messenger product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, visit libertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, December 24th, 2014, Christmas Eve. I'm Brian Hagan reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Zoo visitors watch the mating rituals of the ice cream shop staff, and a serious coworker puts on headphones to focus on his sandwich. Happiness is perpetually fleeting, so try to savor the next few minutes before it disappears once again. This is the Onion Week in Review. FBI officials announced they just can't bring themselves to bust a man who recently downloaded every season of the 1990s television show Picket Fences from a BitTorrent website. While stressing that pirating copyrighted material is strictly illegal, federal authorities expressed their sympathy for the man and claimed that perhaps the story of Sheriff Jimmy Brock and the strange events in a small Wisconsin town is all he has left to cling to.
We have more than enough evidence to bust him for piracy, but if the poor guy really wants to watch all four seasons of a 20-year-old CBS drama that nobody remembers, he's clearly going through a pretty big rough patch right now. Frankly, we don't need to make it any worse.
For statistical purposes, we have seized all private data from your personal computer, and we are disgusted with your recent internet search history. You sick f***. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the live Christmas Day edition of the program. As always, we will take your calls about anything you might like to discuss. All you have to do is dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. You can also join us via Skype. That's Skype username lrn.fm. So feel free to hook up with us that way. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Objectivist Girl. Oh, wait, just kidding. And Johnson.
Yeah, Johnson's here with me on this Christmas Day edition. It's actually kind of fun. We've had last night, Chris Cantwell was here for Christmas Eve, and Chris Cantwell is a card-carrying atheist.
Mm-hmm.
And you are also mostly
Depends on who's looking at the card.
But you did say on the air recently that you would choose the term atheist to describe yourself here on Free Talk Live. And on Sunday night, you were on Sunday as well this week, because Mark's out for till further notice. But you were on Sunday, and we started doing the atheist commandments. There's 10 commandments now, written by, I guess, some sort of atheist group that had taken submissions from people online and, you know, sort of picked the best commandments. All 10 were not written by the same person. You know, the 10 were submitted and then basically kind of looked at, assessed, and voted upon. We will get into those here in a moment. And then coming up, we've talked prior to tonight on Free Talk Live about these state religious displays that will show up at Oklahoma City's state capitol, Florida's state capitol. Specifically, we talked about the Florida state capitol, where there's multiple groups who demanded equal time with the Christian nativity scene that would have been put up at the state capitol. They were granted that, and so I think the Flying Spaghetti Monster had been there in the past. I don't know if it was there this year, but the Satanic Temple had put forth a holiday display.
I have my own Flying Spaghetti Monster on display.
Do you?
Yeah.
Where's that?
I created a holiday lights Flying Spaghetti Monster.
And is that at your house?
Yes, it is.
Oh, very cool. Was that like hang in the window? Nice. Did you take a picture of it somewhere?
I posted one online last year, I think.
I was going to say, it could be fun to put that on the Free Talk Live Facebook page. So we'll get into the Ten Commandments here. Also, the story about a Catholic warrior who came into the Florida Capitol. She's 54 years old, caught on video and caught by security guards vandalizing the Satanic Temple display.
Whenever I hear that, I always think back to that one episode. I think it was of a show called, was it Wife Swap?
I've heard of the show. I don't know if that's what, you know, to
it was either Wife Swap or it was a similar type of show, and I can't remember the name, but I think it was Wife Swap, where they swapped with a Wiccan or some sort of spirit and a
like
real
a
Christ warrior Christian family.
That
and this one woman just was screaming about how she was a Christ warrior and everything was of the devil. And it was fantastic.
Let's go to Mac. He's in Seattle. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Johnson. And happy holidays to you, Mac. Go ahead.
Yeah, happy holidays, fellas. And unlike a lot of Christians, I guess Christian statists, I actually do wish for peace on earth and goodwill towards all men, including you guys.
Yeah, I think the whole idea of being a Christian warrior is kind of ridiculous. Wasn't Jesus supposed to be a man of peace? Just saying. Anyway, go ahead.
Right. Well, and then all day long on my Facebook page, I've seen so-called Christians. I guess I could say preface that by saying so-called Christians, you know, asking us to pray for our warriors who can't be home for Christmas and so forth. And it's just so contrary to what I thought the Christianity was supposed to be about.
The reason
why I'm calling is because my stepson and I, the other day, we were talking about all this stuff going on with the cops these days. And I know you don't want it to become cop block radio, but it is in the news.
It is.
And he's 31 years old. I guess that makes him a little bit younger than you, Ian.
Mm-hmm.
And he was actually caught up in the middle. He was just trying to go home from work after the riots in Seattle about, I don't know, 10 years ago or so, for the World Trade Conference or whatever the heck that
G20 or something
was going on.
Yeah.
The G7, G20, yeah,
whatever it was.
Yeah, he was just trying to go home from work, and he was rounded up by the police. He was corralled by them and then pepper sprayed, and all the poor guy was trying to do was go home from his job.
Wrong place, wrong time.
We were talking about all this police. You got it, yeah. And we were talking about all this police stuff, and he said, "Well, you know, gosh, wasn't it better when you were a kid? And I started to say, just like almost as a habit, because, you know, when you get up to my age, I'm almost 50 now, you start thinking that the old days must certainly have been better. And I almost said, well, yeah, I mean, the police weren't like this when I was a kid. But then I realized, hold on a second, I'm from the Deep South. And in the early 70s, when I was a little kid, if you were looking at the police, you were literally looking at the KKK, particularly in the town where I was from. And so maybe it wasn't, maybe it was better for white people, but I don't think it was better in general.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So, I, you know, yeah, we kind of, we talked about that a little bit. And, you know, and even back then, even if you weren't white and if you weren't in the South, you know, the Dirty Harry movies were made because there was that kind of stuff going on. San Francisco was particularly notorious for having cruel, abusive police. Dirty Harry, of course, was a caricature, but, you know, that kind of stuff actually did go on to some degree. Seattle was known for being pretty
bad. Why wouldn't it have?
I know Chicago, Detroit, and New York City.
Why wouldn't it have, right? I mean, why wouldn't the police in the past be corrupt as well? I mean, they are still men with power and virtually no accountability over their actions. And in point of fact, you know, 30 years ago, there were even fewer people with video devices, far fewer people. And so therefore fewer opportunities to actually record the police in the misbehavior that they might have been committing. It was really the Rodney King beatings that were caught on video in the early 1990s, I believe, that kind of broke that whole world open to us. And now, you know, with the proliferation of video devices on basically every single phone, 60% of American adults now have, or I think it's just 60% of everybody in America has a smartphone. And so therefore everybody's got a video camera, which means that we can shine more light on the corruption. We can view and visit and share with these various different interactions with the police that would have been impossible just a decade ago, let alone two or three decades ago. And I think that makes it maybe seem like things are worse today, but maybe they're not. Maybe today we're just seeing more of what really goes on.
Right, exactly. You know, and then it's funny, just when you said that about Rodney King, it just made me think back now. You know, I'm from the old South, and I have older relatives that were raised to be racist. And my aunt, she was no exception. She didn't, you know, act. She didn't support the KKK, for example, but she just sort of was raised with this attitude where being white, she was better than black people. Mm-hmm. And when the Rodney King video came out, I was actually sitting in her living room, and they said in the news on CNN or whatever it was that Rodney King had planned on suing them. His lawyer was trying to get $1 million per baton strike, which I think was something like $30 or $40 million or something like that. And she looked at me and she said, I hope he gets every nickel.
Wow.
Just like that. So kind of funny how, yeah, you know, this old racist, I hate to say it about my dear aunt, but the truth is the truth. This old racist white lady, she just hated to see that. She hated to see that poor guy beaten like that. But yeah, I think you're right. I think it's the proliferation, the ubiquitousness of video cameras, handheld video cameras that's bringing that to light. Because what could you do in 1970 or 1969 if you were beaten by the police? What could you do? Go and file a piece of paper with the local police department, right? I mean, that was your only option, wasn't it?
Mac, thanks for calling tonight. Appreciate hearing from you on this live Thanksgiving Day edition of Free Talk Live.
I got in a conversation with someone the other day who said that she was really weirded out about cameras because about, like, especially the police now having lapel cameras, because she said there was a cop who she knew for 10 years and was really friendly to her, and that he just started acting really weird because he was on his police dash cam.
Okay.
And that he was acting very robotic and not like himself, and there was no leeway, no discretion at all, because she felt that he was trapped into acting mindlessly and only officially because he was on camera.
Yeah,
and she was afraid that it was going to take away their ability to have any discretion. I was like, as though they were. And I commented to her and said, you know, as though they're using their discretion now.
Yeah, sometimes they are. Yes. We got the cops who call in to say that they, you know, will let a kid go if he's got pot or something. Just take the pot and let him go.
Yeah.
I mean, that's discretion to some extent, and I think that's a legitimate concern and a legitimate complaint about the idea of police cameras. on their lapels. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, the 10 Atheist Commandments. We'll get into it.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The U.S. Constitution protects our freedoms through a system that separates and confines government power. America's founding fathers were wary of government and tried to use the Constitution to limit its reach in many ways. They divided the government into three branches, legislative, executive, and judicial, each able to limit the actions of the others. While this system can lead to what some people call gridlock, our founders considered it the best system for preventing politicians from violating our most fundamental rights. They also separated the national government from state governments, leaving most power at the local level. Our founders added a Bill of Rights that further limits the power of government. The Constitution doesn't create efficient government. It was created to protect us from government overreach. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love, and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here to bring up anything you'd like at 855-450-FREE. It's the Christmas Day edition of the program, and joining you in the studio, it's Ian.
And Johnson.
And if you care about Bitcoin, or you're just curious about it, the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference is coming up in just a few months from now, March 28th and the 29th. It's going to be happening at the Moody Theater right in downtown Austin, which I'm excited about. The first one we attended last year and broadcast live. We'll be doing the same thing this year, or in 2015. And last year was at a kind of a racetrack outside of Austin. This one's going to be right in the heart of downtown, which I think is going to bring the event to the next level. Looking forward to it. Speakers, exhibitions, a great opportunity to do some networking, as well as hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. The second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference will be highlighting what Bitcoin means to everyone, as well as concentrating on where the technology can go just beyond being a currency. If you want a glimpse into the future, you'll want to be in Austin, Texas on March 28th and 29th. Go to texasbitcoinconference.com, get your tickets there, and when you do, use code FTL to save $25 off of the $150 admission price. Now, $150 is already a pretty good price for a weekend conference, but you knock that $25 off by using code FTL. Plus, Texas Bitcoin Conference will donate $25 of the dollars to Sean's Outpost with every ticket purchase when you use the Free Talk Live code. So do use code FTL at texasbitcoinconference.com when you get your tickets, and we will look forward to seeing you there March 28th and 29th at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin. That's texasbitcoinconference.com.
Yeah.
Code FTL.
This thing with the interview has made a lot of theaters seem moody.
Now, there are some theaters who are playing the interview.
Right. It's like, we're playing it. We're not playing it. We're playing it.
Well, at first, the main, the Sony folks decided to pull the movie after five of the major theater chains decided to pull the movie.
Right.
But then Sony came back and said, all right, well, we'll release it limited release. And then certain theaters signed on for it. More independent, I think, theaters decided to take it. And of course, they are also now offering the movie online via YouTube.
Right.
Which is very interesting. It's kind of
and torrent.
I don't think they're
officially offered. It's also being offered that way too.
I'm pretty sure that's an unofficial means of
someone's offering it.
That's true. But this movie, of course, for those that don't know, maybe you're just now tuning in and you've never heard this story. I guess this interview movie by Sony was there was, of course, the news about the Sony hacks, all kinds of emails, and there was major, you know, violations of their security system. And these hackers downloaded several movies, like terabytes of information or whatever, and they released a lot of that stuff. They released all these emails, and in the midst of all this, there was some suggestion that Sony better not release the interview, this new movie coming out, this comedy film, and if they did, then something bad was going to happen, was essentially the suggestion by these this hack group calling themselves the GOP. And now they have released the movie in movie theaters, and so, you know, will something bad occur? I guess, you know, we'll find out. Here we are most of the way through Christmas Day, which was the release date, and I haven't heard anything about a theater shooting or bombing, thank goodness.
What's also interesting, though, is the experiment, you know, and I've had this discussion earlier today and been rebuffed in my theories here, but I think it also makes for a very interesting experiment in same-day theatrical and online release.
Well, that's just it. It is the first time I think that's ever occurred.
Well,
right?
I was told apparently Disney has done this in the past, but I don't know
really?
If that's true. Yeah,
I'd be very interested to know about that, because it seems like Sony, it's almost like they were forced into this, you know, to some extent by circumstance. But it'll be interesting to see how it all pans out in the end, because
make a bunch of money.
Because there's been a crap load of publicity for this movie as a result of all the news. And so, you know, what kind of cut? I wonder, you know, of the $6 cost they're asking for this movie on YouTube, how much of that actually goes to Sony versus YouTube? And is that a greater cut than what they would get from a ticket sale in any average theater?
Right.
I wonder about that. Let's go to Mike in Oregon. You're on Free Talk Live. And Mike, what's on your mind tonight here on Christmas Day?
Hey, Merry Christmas, Ian and Johnson. How are you
Welcome,
doing?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts, Mike.
Well, two things, actually. I just want to let you know that I gave my girlfriend very first 3 pounds of BuzzBox coffee today.
Oh, and, wow, cool.
Yeah, it's kind of late in the day, but figured, you know, one cup isn't going to kill me. But so we made 4 cups of coffee, and we tried it, and it's absolutely delicious.
Oh, yeah. Fantastic.
And, you know, I know you're not like a coffee drinker, but try it just once, and I'll tell you, there's no bite to it. There's no stale bite like all the other store-bought coffee. It's great stuff.
I'm a huge coffee drinker. I'm a coffee snob. I've been drinking it since I was very young. And I'm curious, what type? Did you get, like, a variety? I don't even know that enough about it, but did you get, like, a variety, or did you get
I think you just get one flavor for the free pound.
Well, he said he did more than 1 pound.
Well, it wasn't the one flavor one. What I did was I went through your website, coffee.freetalklab.com.
Mm-hmm.
And then I hit shop, and then I went to the gift pack, and it says, you know, you get to choose three. Well, the people who work there will choose 3 pounds of their, you know, what their favorite is, whatever, and they put it in the pack, and they pack some mint in there. So we got the medium Papua New Guinea roast, and I think a dark roast and a light roast. But
the medium Papua New Guinea, it's funny. You said that one, and then you said a dark roast and a light roast. And it's funny because you probably are like me. I think that medium Papua New Guinea is my favorite.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's good stuff.
Actually, there's one more thing I just remembered I wanted to talk to you about was the jury nullification, Ian, about I heard the other night about someone was going to actually be posting stuff in New York City about jury nullification. And
yes,
I actually had seen, I had actually got called to jury duty when I was living in New Hampshire, up in North Haverhill, New Hampshire. And of course, you know, like anybody, they don't want to go to jury duty. And I had to go in and use the bathroom. So I finally get to the courthouse, and I see you guys standing outside the courthouse handing out literature. And I knew nothing about the Free State Project back then. But, Ian, I think I saw you. You were wearing a black leather jacket, and you were passing out, you know, about the jury nullification of literature.
Yeah.
And I think I just took it, and I was like, oh, it's probably about the court and stuff. And I wasn't interested because I wanted to get back to work. But then when I went in and they actually chose us to sit on the jury, the judge comes out and he says, hi, you know, thank you for all showing up or whatever. There's a group outside known as Free Staters, and they're handing out literature about the courts. And he didn't, I don't think he talked about jury nullification, but he said the only literature that is valid is what is handed out by the court. And it, again, at the time.
Wow.
Right.
When was this?
And everyone laughed. This was, oh gosh, I want to say 2005 or 2006, maybe.
It must have been 06 because I wasn't here in 2005, but it does sound like, you know, it definitely sounds like something I would do. That's interesting. Okay, well, so everyone laughed at that?
Well, when the judge was standing out, he was in the courthouse, in the actual, like, room, and he was kind of in front of the bench, and he had said, the literature that they're passing out there is not relevant. It's only relevant. The only literature that is relevant is what is handed out by the court, and they're known as Free Staters, and everyone kind of laughed. And again, I didn't know what it was, but looking back on it now, I'm not surprised you said that, because again, you guys are a threat to the state. Anything that gets the public informed of, you know, what's right and wrong instead of legal versus illegal is going to be a threat to this monopoly.
Well, okay, so Mike, I'm curious, what did you think about that at that time when he was saying that to you? Because it sounds like that was your first encounter with jury nullification information, right?
Yeah, I didn't know much about it, but...
Hold that thought, Mike. If you don't mind, I'd like to bring you back to continue that discussion. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Jury nullification or whatever's on your mind goes here on Free Talk Live.
It's that time of year again, and you know what that means, cold and flu season. But don't worry, HerbalHealer.com has you and your loved ones covered with our safe and natural products. Cold and flu fighters like beta-glucans, olive leaf antiviral capsules, grapefruit seed extract, HHA 4-herb capsules, elderberry power, and respirate. And don't forget about oregacillin for the lungs, normally $34.95, on sale now for only $25. Vitamin D3, 120-count soft gels, only $9. Whole body and homeopathic detoxes for the lungs, kidneys, liver, lymph, and brain, normally $26.95, now just $20. HerbalHealer.com also offers correspondence courses to teach you how to handle your health naturally. And as always, new customers get a free 128-page catalog with your order. Visit HerbalHealer.com and click the Winter Specials button to save on our natural cold and flu-fighting products. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999, and ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and it is the live Christmas Day edition of the program. We're here live, and thanks to our great board operator, Kyle, over at the Genesis Communications Network for coming in and doing the show, because I'm pretty sure there aren't too many other radio shows that are live on Christmas Day, but we're here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's bring Mike back on the line here in Clackamas, Oregon. He's calling to... tell us a story about actually being apparently in Keene, New Hampshire, where I was handing out jury nullification information. And this was almost, you said, several years ago, back in 2006, maybe, Mike, which I don't even know if I was doing jury outreach back then. But, you know, what the way you described it sounds like something I would have been doing. And you said that when you got into the courthouse, when the judge came out to address the potential jurors, that he actually specifically said something to the effect of, there are people out front passing out information, and you are to only regard or hold as legitimate the information that we give to you here in the courthouse. Is that right?
Correct. This was actually not in Keene. This was in North Haven, New Hampshire, way up near the Vermont border.
Oh, then that wouldn't have been me. I definitely would. I'm sorry. I maybe misheard what you were saying earlier. Yeah, that definitely was not me. But nonetheless, interesting that... Yeah. You had that experience. So when you heard the judge make those claims, what did you think about it?
Well, it takes some connecting of dots. First, when I had, because I, like most people, you don't want to do jury duty because it's a pain, and you just, you know, don't want to do it. You want to go back to work and earn your money because they don't really pay for any of that.
Yeah.
So when I got there, I saw... potentially, what I thought was, you know, the Free Staters standing outside of the courtroom at the building and handing out stuff on jury nullification. And I think I had heard about it. I just didn't know much about it. I mean, this is, you know, 9 years ago. So I didn't really read anything into it because I wasn't interested in this whole system. I just wanted out. So when I got in there, we waited in a room for a while. And then we went into the actual courtroom, and there was a huge audience. And the judge came out and he said, there's a group of people standing outside known as the Free Staters, and everyone laughed. And they're passing out literature, and the only literature that you should consider legitimate is the one that is, the court gives you. And again, I didn't really think too much of it because I didn't know what I knew now about it. But now, looking back, if I had known what you guys were actually passing out and how powerful this is, I would have definitely been interested more in, staying on jury and hopefully getting picked. The trial.
Did you receive the information from the people who were passing it out, or did you refuse to receive it?
No, I took it because I thought it was people who worked for the court. That's why I wasn't really interested in reading. And I could have sworn it was Julian because there was a guy with a black leather jacket. He handed it to me with a goatee, and I could have sworn it was you. And this is up in North Haverhill.
Well, I guess from what I understand, I had to go and look that up. Apparently it's Grafton County. I have been to the Grafton County Courthouse, but it's only been on a couple of occasions, and I don't know if I would have gone that early in my time in New Hampshire. I know I was up there at one point when Weta Claus was on trial, but I don't recall doing jury outreach on that day in particular. But again, it's been a while since that happened. But regardless of all those details, there is a group of folks who does jury nullification outreach on a regular basis in Grafton County, and so it's certainly possible that that you encountered one of them. And by no means am I the only leather jacket owning, goatee sporting, liberty activist up here. But yeah, I've never heard that. It's actually interesting that that's an interesting story and it's believable. But the times that I've done it here in New Hampshire, I've never actually had anyone tell me about that. And there have been a couple of times where Free State Project participants have been on the jury pool. So I'll be standing out front and someone I know will come in. Like there was one time the president of the Free State Project at the time, Baron Swearingen, came in. Another lady named Shauna lives here. She came in and did it. And, I would have expected if something like that happened to them that they would have informed us about it. But maybe this is a one-time occurrence, or maybe it's just that one judge, or maybe it happens more often than we realize. It's interesting.
When I was sitting in the audience and the judge was actually saying this, because you're in this, dark room and where the judge is sitting, it's all brightly lit and everything's all nice. You get the American flag and the black robe. What he's saying kind of scares you. It's like, because of the perception of legitimacy.
Right.
You actually kind of think, so the judge is right. But when you're outside and you're actually reading about jury nullification, it's like, the Free States, they have a point. And I'm all for jury nullification because I think you should be taking into consideration that the person who's actually on trial didn't hurt anyone. I mean, I think it was like a drug charge or a Xanax, or I think the guy was driving without, it was a young kid, like 18 years old, driving without a license. And at the time, it's like, I just want out. But now looking back, it's like, this kid didn't hurt anyone. And now, it's like, we're talking about a human life here. And we only know what it's like to be alive. We don't know what it's like to not exist. And to take that, to put the squeeze on someone and put them through the gears of the system does an incredible amount of mental damage to someone, especially someone who's just starting life. Why would they want to go and hurt someone?
So it's interesting you had this interaction or you had this encounter with jury nullification information. It didn't really resonate with you at that moment. The judge sort of short-circuited that possibility, and that can be a scary thing. You're in that courthouse. It's an intimidating environment, and when a man with a robe who has men with guns will do his every bidding tells you something like, well, our literature is the only legitimate literature.
What's interesting is if I had been told that, no, it wouldn't have been scary to me. I would have been like, really? Let me read what this thing is that I was handed.
Yeah, but you're different kind of than the average person going to jury duty. The average person is intimidated
by the system.
But I'm
thinking, even before I was any kind of libertarian activist, I mean, I think that...
Were you anti-authoritarian beforehand, though? Because I was.
I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So I would have been the same way, but, not everybody's that way. Mike, do you think there's a better approach? I mean, is there a better time? Had you been sent that same flyer in the mail a week before the trial, would that have made it more or less likely that you would have taken it and read over it?
I would have definitely read over it more. But I mean, I think that it was bad timing because back when I was living in New Hampshire, I was only, maybe 24, maybe 25 years old. The fact that I've been listening to your show for, a couple of years now, it's made an impact really mentally on me. And I know so much more now, especially about jury nullification than I did, you know, I hardly knew anything about it back when I had gotten that literature. And of course, it was just literature, and I just eventually tossed it, but I wish I had kind of kept it because I would have kind of gotten a jump on things ahead of time. But
so I got to know, Mike, why'd you leave New Hampshire, and what are you doing in Clackamas, Oregon?
I was the guy who was going to wait in the liquor store, remember?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yeah.
So, oh, cool.
But, I mean, if I ever called into the with jury duty out here, am I allowed to – I mean, I know that jury duty, jury nullification can't be mentioned, but when we're all going to kind of debate about whether the person is guilty, am I allowed to say, hey, I know about something called jury nullification to the jury, or is that even allowed –
I can't give you legal advice on that. I don't really know for sure, you know, what the rules are or if that would somehow get you into trouble. I think that the folks, if I'm recalling correctly, the folks over the Fully Informed Jury Association have recommended not mentioning that terminology in any point in the courthouse, and just I don't know what the best approach is there. I would say that you should be safe in exercising your right to nullify. But I wonder, you know, what consequences may befall someone who is a little bit too blabby about what exactly they're doing. I honestly don't know, and I don't want to point you in the wrong direction. So I would consult with the Fully Informed Jury Association on that one, because I imagine things are different in Oregon than they are here in New Hampshire.
Yeah, I mean, I think you can do it like, you know, if you ever get called into a jury and a few people know about it and they keep their mouth shut, but vote, hey, not guilty if the guy hasn't hurt anyone. I definitely think that could probably, you know, probably make a difference. I don't know what the majority has to be. It has to be
unanimous to set the person free. So it would be useful to be able to try to persuade the other jurors. And either way, they're going to try to push you into a guilty. And if you're holding fast, then you may be able to, that level of a will may be able to flip some people. But, you know, anybody that's ever been on the inside of a deliberation room and wants to tell their story should do that. Thanks, Mike, for your call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Atheist Commandments coming up.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
It's the end of year clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. We'd rather sell it than count it. So every floor and every store is on sale, and it all must go. Get incredible deals on first quality flooring from just 35 cents a square foot. Beautiful 3/4 inch pre-finished solid hardwood is just $179. Save even more on all liquidation clearance and closeouts. If it's in stock, it's on sale, and pay no interest until January 2017. Don't miss these end-of-year deals in over 400 floors. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Never, ever send a follow-up email asking, "Did you get my email?" Email 101, if it didn't bounce back undeliverable, it got where you sent it. And avoid transmedia pestering, like calling to ask, "Did you get my email?" or emailing to say, "I left you a voicemail." If your emails and voicemails aren't being acknowledged, your problem isn't technology, it's technique. Is your message concise and understandable? Have you boiled it down to seem as relevant as possible to the recipient? In other words, Is it the opposite of spam or junk mail? All of this really matters if you're a job seeker. But even if you're not, with money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free here and bring up anything you want at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Johnson.
And Free Talk Live is brought to you by Victimless Crime Spree, makes perfect belated holiday gift. You can go and order it now at victimlesscrimespree.com or just watch it for free online. It's our friend Derek J., who is arrested 5 times in a 1-year time frame, and it's all on video. You can go and enjoy it. VictimlessCrimeSpree.com. Our toll-free number here tonight, it is, by the way, the live Christmas Day edition, is 855-450-FREE. We were talking about the gentleman who had experienced a judge talking crap about liberty activists up here, free staters, people who, like you and I, Johnson, moved to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. The idea is to gather as many liberty-minded people, hopefully 20,000 of them, all in one place so that we can get active to achieve more liberty in our lifetime. And of course, there are going to be some people who don't appreciate the kind of work that we're doing, which a lot of that work is outreach and education, trying to...
Work! You don't work! Get a job!
One of the most frequent critiques of the liberty activists is that we are not jobby enough, I guess.
Did you start a business? Get a job!
Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous.
Do you have a job? It looks like you have a job. Get a job!
The guy, one of the guys who's most notorious for saying that, just drove by the studio earlier today and flipped somebody the bird as he was driving by. So, yes, some people don't like the fact that we're here and that we're doing things and that we're spreading the ideas of freedom, and they're going to try to oppose us at every turn. In this case, a judge secretly informing the jury that had come in that they need to disregard, essentially, the information that they've been given by liberty activists outside of the courthouse. And we should expect to see more of that and expect to see it outside of New Hampshire as well, like in New York City, where Ross Ulbricht will be going to trial here on, I think, January 5th is the beginning of that trial. It's going to be a really important federal case where Ross is facing the rest of his life in prison for ostensibly being the man who ran the Silk Road underground drug marketplace. There are going to be liberty activists on the scene there who will also be handing out information to people going into the courthouse. There will be billboards that have been purchased in the area. And by the way, we do have that, let's see, I think it was the, oh man, Jury Rights Project, jrp.io/NYC. JRP, like Jury Rights Project, right. .io/NYC for New York City. Right. That's where you can go to donate to this fundraiser that they're trying to raise around $3,000 to buy this, these several billboards outside of the courthouse there. So you can expect the same behavior from the status inside that building, trying to dissuade jury members from understanding and applying the ideas of jury nullification, which of course is your right as a juror to vote your conscience in a case. Even if the law itself is pretty, maybe it was crystal clear the law's been broken, you can still vote not guilty.
So you mentioned the Silk Road. Now, you know, I haven't been paying attention. Is Is Silk Road 3 up and running? I know there was a Silk Road 2 and it got shut down.
Been in the last few weeks, but after Silk Road 2 was shut down, Silk Road 3 did pop up. And okay. apparently it was actually an already online site that they rebranded as Silk Road 3 from what I heard.
Right.
But yeah, well, I mean, I went and I looked at it a few weeks ago and it was there, but I have not checked. I've not checked with
I'm sure it's still going.
But yeah, I mean, the Silk Road probably will not end anytime soon. It's just the brand is too valuable, although I imagine the brand will be diluted the more times it continues to get taken down by the
feds.
I know
the Pirate Bay is down currently.
What is going on with that? I know that the news hit a couple weeks ago. I'd meant to talk about it on the air, but it's one of the many stories we never really covered here on Free Talk Live. The Pirate Bay was taken down in a raid by police, and you're saying it's still down, but there are mirrors that appear to be online. So
the mirrors are not the full Pirate Bay, though.
Well, what's the point of mirroring it if you're not going to mirror the whole site?
Yeah, that's kind of how I feel about it, too. But, I mean, it saves a bunch of the torrents. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it does, you know, save a bunch of the older torrents because there are a lot of old torrents that have been around for a long, long time. And mirroring those, because of the way the distributed nature of torrents work, it keeps the torrents up and running. But, yeah, I mean, there are certain, like, newer torrents and whatnot that are, you know...
So there's a website called thepiratebay.cr, and that's where it looks like the Pirate Bay. You can search. The search seems...
I don't know. There's also oldpiratebay.org. I don't know if the same. Yeah, so...
Well, the weird thing about this piratebay.cr is that everything says it was uploaded today, and it always says that no matter which day I'm going to the website. Like, I'm jumping in, you know, 20 pages in or whatever, and it still says... Everything was uploaded today. So, yeah, I don't know.
Interesting.
I wonder if you can still upload, you know, new stuff to the site. I haven't tried that.
I found a interesting thing. The Pirate Bay returning soon. Torrent site waves flag in previously closed domain. The Torrent Royalty Bay Torrent Royalty, the Pirate Bay, refuses to sink and go down that easy. After the Swedish police exterminated the site in hopes of diminishing and eliminating the torrenting activities online, the task seemed to have backfired as the torrent giant remained anchored into its original domain. Previously, the PirateBay.se was rendered inaccessible after the takedown, but now those who visit it will now be welcomed with a huge image of the Torrent King's waving flag. Many are led to believe, including the media outlet Torrent Freak, that Pirate Bay is hinting its glorious return. Yeah. PC Mag reports that the site is being hosted on a server in Moldova. The site added this to the major curator's first location and executing the major restoration of the site. Nothing is confirmed at the moment. That is indeed what is happening, but speculations that collaboration between another torrent hub called ISO Hunt and the Pirate Bay is making headway to reestablish the fallen site. It is important to note that ISO Hunt has done its best in bringing back the site shortly after its wipeout by creating mirrored links of archives of the Pirate Bay, hence the Open Bay quickly made rounds in the online world. We, the team that brought you isohunt.to and the oldpiratebay.org, just oldpiratebay.org, are bringing you the next step in the torrent evolution, Open Pirate Bay source code. A history of torrent sites such as ISO Hunt and the Pirate Bay give us a lesson that would be a crime not to learn. The era of individual torrent sites is over, reads a statement in the Open Bay. That is why we created Pirate Bay open source.
What are they going to do? I mean, how's that going to change things?
Yep, it's free for everyone. Now you can create your own copy of the Pirate Bay. Update and change this code and make it better for everyone. As per Torrent Freak, developing a carbon copy of the Pirate Bay will be nothing but great for its creatives. We've always lived by copy me. I don't know what that means. Oh, copy me. K-O-P-I-M-I. Apparently that's a term that says copy me. We love being cloned. It would be amazing if, like in the classic movie Spartacus, everyone could stand up and say,
I am the Pirate Bay.
The Pirate Bay, Mr. 10100100000, told Torrent Freak.
So where was that notice posted? Where did that come from?
Apparently there's
Torrent
still,
Freak site?
Yeah. That's
because right now on
probably
the Pirate
oldpiratebay.org. Oldpiratebay.org.
What I'm wondering is, how do they retain control of their domain name? I mean, it's if the feds or whoever it was, the Finnish government or whoever did the takedown, Swedish. I don't know who it was. But
Swedish, yeah, it was Swedish police.
So why didn't they appropriate the domain name? I mean, normally when like the U.S. gang takes down a website, they have that big splash screen that comes up where it shows all the gang symbols from the governments, and it says, "Oh, we took your, you know, we took your domain name." If you go to the piratebay.se right now, you can see there's what appears to be, I don't know if it's a caricature of Kim Jong-un or whoever the hell that is, some sort of dictator-looking guy. And then there's a fluttering Jolly Roger, you know, skull and two swords in this case, crossbones. And then at the top, strangely, there's a counter, but it's counting up.
That's
so, it, you know, you'd think, you know, usually when you go to a website and they're getting ready to launch something, the counter counts down to zero.
Right.
This one's counting up, and it looks like there's eight digits with, you know, two digits apiece, two numerals each, 16:19:56:36, and the 37, 38, 39, it's counting up faster than seconds would count, too. So, I don't know what that's about.
I don't know. Could it be a hit counter, an old school hit counter?
You would think they'd be getting more hits than that. I don't know. It's very strange. I mean, it's a very consistent count. Like it's moving at the maybe you're right. Maybe it is a hit counter. And there's a strange code at the bottom and another code on the left hand side of the page. So I imagine somebody's probably already figured this out. This is like it almost looks like it's some kind of a puzzle.
Right.
Like there's a bunch of essentially scrambled information at the bottom. It looks like it's encrypted information to some extent. I thought for a moment that it might have been a Bitcoin address, but Bitcoin addresses always have the one in front of them.
Right.
So it's not a Bitcoin address. I wonder what's going on with that. The piratebay.se, clearly not in the hands of the government unless this is some sort of government page that's been put up there. I don't think that's the case. Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you know more about it. You're welcome to share with us. Plus, the Atheist Commandments will continue coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Chuck Woolery here. You know, I've talked before about Australian Dream, the effective arthritis pain relief cream that doesn't burn, isn't greasy, and has no odor. Now there's new Australian Dream back pain cream with all those great benefits. But this penetrating formula can help relieve your simple back pain. And it's backed by an empty jar guarantee. If you're not satisfied, you can send back the empty jar for a full refund. But I don't think you will, because Australian Dream really works. Don't let back pain ruin your day. Get Australian Dream back pain cream at Walgreens.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, December 25th, 2014. Silver is trading at $15.77 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,175 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $322. Antiwar.com reports the U.S.-led coalition has lost its first warplane of the war against the Islamic State in Syria as the Islamic State shot down a Jordanian F-16 with a heat-seeking missile, capturing the pilot. The Islamic State issued images of the captured pilot being paraded around the capital city of Raqqa. Jordan warned they are holding the Islamic State responsible for the safety of the captured pilot. That's probably not going to be a serious concern for the Islamic State, since Jordan and the other coalition members are already at war with them and bombing them on a daily basis. It's a much bigger concern for the coalition, as now the Islamic State has proven its capability to shoot down coalition warplanes. It's only a matter of time before they do some more, and as the losses mount, the lack of progress in the war is likely to become a more serious concern.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin.bombs. Bitcoin.bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin.bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit Bitcoin.bombs.com.
Reuters reports Baghdad's embattled Christian community worshipped defiantly Wednesday night at a Christmas Eve Mass. The pews filled at Baghdad's Sacred Heart Church as people remembered the darkest year in memory. Blast walls shielded the church, and seven policemen flanked the outside of the house of worship in an indication of the government's fear of an attack. The congregation sang in unison, "Praise Jesus our Lord, oh praise Him," as incense burned in the darkened building. The worshippers paid tribute to the thousands of Christians displaced this summer in northern Iraq when the Islamic State seized the city of Mosul in June and in August pushed on toward Iraqi Kurdistan, overrunning Christian towns on the Nineveh Plain. Some had personal stories of those displaced this summer in northern Iraq who had scattered to Iraqi Kurdistan, Turkey, and Lebanon. Fadih Rafat, an assistant to the priest, said, "We still exchange blessings and congratulations of Christmas and New Year. We celebrate the happiness of Christmas, but deep inside we carry the sadness of Iraq." The holiday season weighed heavily on some. Earlier in the day, a mother and daughter on a busy street in the neighborhood of Karada argued about whether they should stay in Iraq or give up on the country. The mother insisted she would die in Iraq unafraid, but her daughter longed to escape.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports Alan Gross, freed from imprisonment in Cuba last week, will receive a $3.2 million settlement from a U.S. government agency. Gross was arrested in 2009 and accused of subversion for providing communications equipment to Cuba's Jewish population. He was working for a company contracted to the U.S. Agency for International Development, USAID. The U.S. government maintained he was helping Cubans access the internet in a democracy-building effort. He served 5 years of his 15-year sentence and was released last week as a humanitarian gesture as part of the normalization of relations between the U.S. and Cuba. The settlement between USAID and Development Alternatives Incorporated, DAI, of Bethesda, Maryland, was announced Tuesday by USAID. It ends a claim by DAI of $7 million for unanticipated costs, currently under review by the Civilian Board of Contract Appeals, and a $60 million lawsuit by Gross and his wife against the U.S. government and DAI. They settled with DAI for an undisclosed amount in 2013. Their claim against the U.S. government was rejected by a U.S. district court. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Researchers at Princeton University's Department of Sociology have made a major leap in our understanding of social interaction.
We conducted trials in 90 supermarkets across the country and found that essentially 100% of people disapproved of having a stranger hit them across the face and then expose their genitalia right in the middle of the supermarket, which we found very interesting.
Researchers observed similar reactions when the subject hurled shopping carts toward unsuspecting shoppers, stood in the deli section rubbing cold cuts against his chest, or got right near cashier's ears and began loudly singing Yankee Doodle.
In this particular trial, we had our subject, Kevin, take off his shirt, tape a banana to his forehead, and charge at various shoppers like he was a rhino. Within 20 minutes, store owners called the police and he was arrested, allowing us to come to the conclusion that this type of behavior is still considered at least somewhat taboo.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free here. Bring up anything you'd like. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. So further research has resulted in learning a little bit more about what's going on with the Pirate Bay website. You go to thepiratebay.se, which was their site before the raid. And surprisingly, they appear to still have control over the domain name, which is very exciting. Because it looks like they're planning for a comeback. Determined finally after reading an article what the counter is on the top of the website. It's a counter of time that has elapsed since the raid. So 16 days, 20 hours, 6 minutes, and now 30 seconds in counting. Right. So apparently they actually are seconds that are counting off. I just thought that for whatever reason, I thought it was moving a little faster than seconds. And there's a code on the left-hand side of the page, and apparently it's some sort of encrypted way to access the interview, the movie that has been just recently released by Sony in online venues. So there's still a link to a torrent, I guess, right there on the Pirate Bay website. So we'll see. And it is apparently a caricature of Kim Jong-un, apparently, who is featured here kind of intermingled amongst this waving flag with a skull and crossbones, or in this case a skull and crossed scimitars or whatever on it. So very interesting. We'll certainly keep our eyes on the Pirate Bay and see when it rises yet again, as I imagine it certainly will do, because you can't take one site down like the Silk Road or the Pirate Bay as a, you know, the police cannot take these sites down and have success over time. Someone will replace it. Even if the Pirate Bay didn't come back, there are 70 other torrent sites out there that, you know, are essentially doing the same thing as the Pirate Bay. What is there? Torrents.com with a Z, Torrents with a Z. And then there's Kick-Ass Torrents. I think that's one of them that's fairly popular. So there's several out there that can certainly step up, but it's nice to see that whoever it is that's behind the Pirate Bay is still at it. So share your thoughts with us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Johnson, let's get into the story that we actually started Sunday night and never really got a chance to wrap it up. In fact, we didn't even come close. We had the Ten Commandments as selected by a group of atheists. This is according to CNN.com. Lex Baer, who's an executive at Airbnb, as well as John Figdor, a humanist chaplain at Stanford University, delivered their own 10 non-commandments in a book that they co-wrote called Atheist Heart, Humanist Mind. And what they did was they offered $10,000 to folks. Atheists were asked to offer modern alternatives to the famous Decalogue. The contest drew more than 2,800 submissions from 18 countries and 27 U.S. states. And they were selected by a team of 13 judges. They selected 10 of the most sober and serious submissions. And let's jump into them here. Number one, which is the only one we covered on Sunday night, just a recap, is to be open-minded and willing to alter your beliefs with new evidence, which is kind of an interesting commandment for atheists to hold, because this kind of started our discussion, I think, on Sunday night, Johnson, about, you know, what is an atheist versus an agnostic. And, you know, it seems like a lot of atheists aren't very open-minded towards the idea of there being a God. They've determined that there is no God, and they're fairly certain about that.
I'm as open-minded to there being an idea of a God as I am open-minded to the idea that leprechauns run the universe.
Okay.
I mean, totally open-minded to that possibility.
Meaning that if the leprechauns did show themselves to you, like to peel back sure. the... If the leprechauns all yeah. of a sudden peeled back, you know, a corner of the world to show the clockwork elves or whatever.
Exactly.
Underneath.
Or if, you know, rainbow... if unicorns vomited rainbows in my eyes and it flooded my brain with rainbow magic and suddenly it just opened my eyes.
Number two, I don't know if that means you're, I guess, so you're saying you are open-minded, but saying it in a very not, you know, kind of
well, I mean,
dismissive
way. There's an idea that you have to not be so open-minded that your brain falls out. In other words,
yeah.
someone can see, and there's a great video online by Theremin Trees, I believe it is on YouTube, is the name of the user, who does this video on open-mindedness, and, you know, talks, he relates a story that he was having with a friend where, you know, the friend says, you know, look at this lampshade, is moving of its own accord, you know, it must be ghosts, you know, it must be ghosts, like that it's moving on its own. And the guy says, no, it's a heater, and reaches down and switches the heater and the hot air is moving the mm-hmm. lampshade. And it's like, you know, or no, the guy says, I'm sorry, the discussion, he says, no, it's not ghosts. You're just closed-minded. It's not, you can't believe in anything beyond yourself. You're closed-minded that you don't believe it's ghosts. No,
well, yeah,
this,
you'd have to have more persuasive evidence show that it was actually a ghost.
Yeah, but it's actually the person who's believing that it's ghosts that's closed-minded by not being open to other possibilities. Like, it's ghosts, you know, like...
Oh, absolutely.
Well, you know, and that happens a lot of times if you believe in a religious viewpoint, you've shut your mind to other possibilities. I'm open
absolutely.
To the possibilities, but I need to be shown evidence. You can't just be open to every idea. Not all ideas are created equal.
I totally agree with
and
that.
And there are a ton of bad ideas out there. A ton.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Number two on the list of non-commandments, according to some of the atheists, is strive to understand what is most likely to be true, not to believe what you wish to be true. Number three.
That's also, by the way, we've had him as a guest on the show.
Who?
Terry Goodgun, the author.
Yeah, okay.
He was a little bit militant when we had him on, I guess, you know, it was
a long time ago.
There was back during, you know, a lot of terrorist talk back then. And
oh, yeah, wasn't he like a military kind of dude?
Yeah,
whatever?
he was a little militant. I mean, he's also, he comes from that, he's one of those Ayn Rand objectivists that's very militant. Like, mm-hmm. he doesn't quite get it, in my opinion. But he wrote a great series of books, fantasy novels, which I really like, that are very liberty-minded, the Wizard's First Rule series. And the Wizard's First Rule is the name of the first book in the series.
Right.
And that rule is people can be stupid. And essentially what that means is that people will believe what they either wish to be true or what they fear to be true, rather than the truth. They're not going to seek truth if they're afraid something's true or that they really want something to be true. A lot of the times people are not going to seek fact and truth.
Well, it is more convenient that way.
Right.
Number three, the scientific method is the most reliable way of understanding the natural world. I think that's true.
Yes.
Yeah.
100%.
It's not always right, but the point of the scientific method is to prove things wrong over
right.
time. So, and hopefully come closer to the truth as a result. Number four, every person has the right to control their body, which, of course, I totally agree with,
mm-hmm.
although it seems like a lot of atheists believe in the state,
yeah.
so I wonder how far they would actually take that
right.
particular belief. Like, it sounds nice on its face, but, you know, if I have the right to control my body, then shouldn't that mean that I can, you know, opt out of the state's little
programs and stuff?
Well,
if you're doing drugs, then you've taken away your own right to control your body, and therefore you no longer have that right, and therefore...
Wait, is that an atheist talking?
I don't know. I'm just guessing what an atheist might say.
Like a straight-edge atheist?
Sure, like an atheist. Well, a statist atheist is where I was going with that, is that somebody who would say, like, well, you've sacrificed your right. If you put those substances in your body, then you're no longer in control.
Mm.
So therefore, you gave up that right. So now the state has to take over for you because obviously you're responsible.
Number five, God is not necessary to be a good person or to live a full and meaningful life. And I think this is a message that the atheists have been trying to get out for a while, and that is that they don't need to have some sort of human written, you know, morality system imposed upon them by a religion in order to know right from wrong and in order to choose, you know, to do good and to do the right thing.
I love the call that we got on Sunday night with a person who I can't remember her name, but she pointed out that, you know, the original king of lies or father of lies in the, you know, the story of Adam and Eve and the snake in the garden, the original liar was God. And just what's interesting is that a lot of the morality systems that are taught in the Bible are really people judging and making up their own morals. The morals are not coming from God.
Toll-free number tonight, if you want to comment, share your thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're about five through this list of 10 commandments or non-commandments, as they are called here by the group that came up with them. It was the 10 non-commandments contest. $10,000 was offered as the prize, and 10 were selected. We're halfway through. We'll continue the other five here in moments. You're welcome to share your thoughts at toll-free number 855-450-FREE. And then the atheists are under attack in the Florida Capitol with a Catholic warrior entering the Florida Capitol and attacking the atheists display there. We'll tell you about what happened, and it's Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
They believe, I think, that government can be good as long as you just elect the right people, which, of course, is nonsense. Government can never be good because it's an agency of coercive force. It doesn't matter who's running it. It doesn't matter what the goals of the organization are. As long as it's funded through coercion, as long as it's funded through threats of violence, then nothing it can do is ever moral or justified. They understand the system and they want to work inside it to change it. So, therefore, in order to have their hunger strike that they'd planned, which I thought was a great idea, they went to the government, and what'd they do?
Ask for a permit?
They asked for a permit. They asked for a permit. It was already over at that point, right? Whenever you ask permission from the government, you might as well expect them to say,
no.
No!
You know what? It sounds like government has this non-cooperation thing down to a science.
Yeah, right?
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the Christmas Day edition of the program, and we'll take your calls toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And joining you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Johnson.
Join us online at freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing here at Free Talk Live, then you can go and support the show by shopping with us. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. Enter Amazon through the link you'll find there. There's Amazon Canada, Amazon US, and Amazon UK. You just click into the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live will get a cut of your purchase. It's that simple. You've got shopping you're going to need to do at some point, so you might as well shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. When you do, it makes a big difference for us every day of the year. We really appreciate it. So again, that's shop.freetalklive.com. We are on the 10 non-commandments, as one atheist group is calling them. These are some ideas that, you know, aren't necessarily about morality, but the one that we did just read is that says that God is not necessary to be a good person or to live a full and meaningful life. And as someone who spent many years as an atheist, I can definitely empathize with them on this. It's definitely the case that atheists, most of the ones I've ever known, have been good people who care about others and who, you know, are willing to give to charity and help out with charities and things like that. You don't see a whole lot of atheist charities, but there certainly are atheists who are working for charities and with charities. And I imagine that if there are atheists that are running charities, they're probably just not wearing their atheism on their sleeve.
Right. And I met plenty of good Christians, but I will say this. A lot of the worst people I've ever met are devoutly religious. A lot of the worst, most awful people are the ones who think that they can just do whatever they want and they're going to get forgiveness, you know, later. That they can just ask forgiveness and they'll be forgiven by God and they can just do whatever horrible, awful things that they want and there'll be atonement at some point in the future. And just, that's, you know, and I'm not saying that that's all Christians by any stretch of the imagination, but I think that there maybe does take some level of religious devoutness to get to that level. Or I don't know, you know?
Yeah, I don't know either. I mean, I can't say that when I was a Christian that I would have been aware of those people, because I was only a Christian when I was a young child for the most part. And then when I became a teenager, it was at like 13 that I was asking some pretty tough questions, and basically I became an atheist.
I've definitely known some Christians who are aware of those people.
Yeah. No, you know, I mean, I believe that that they exist. Right. I just, when I was younger, I didn't know that they did. But certainly we hear Christians, so-called Christians, calling this show often enough.
Sure.
Sounding anything but Christian in the way that their rhetoric, you know, is expressed.
And there are a lot of Christians who also believe that the other Christians are doing it wrong. No matter
well, that's
what.
Fairly common. I would say that's fairly common among Christians because there's so many different subsets. Number six on the list, be mindful. This is, by the way, being reported by CNN.com. Be mindful of the consequences of all of your actions and recognize that you must take responsibility for them. It's a good one. Number seven, treat others as you would want them to treat you and can reasonably expect them to want to be treated. Think about their perspective. And I like that one, too.
I like the way that that's phrased because, you know, if you start out and just say treat others as you want them to treat you, it's not enough.
Right, because, like, what if you're a sadist?
Right.
You know, like, what if you are a masochist, you know, for instance? Obviously, that's not an appropriate way to treat people without their consent.
Right.
You know? Number eight, we have the responsibility to consider others, including future generations.
I don't agree with this one.
What do you mean?
You have the responsibility. I don't like that terminology. That's where we're starting to get into this.
Yeah, it sounds like an obligation.
You know, an obligation to consider the future and consider others. And, you know, no, I don't agree with that at all.
I think
you should consider yourself, and that should be, you know, the extent of it. And if you're smart and you feel like it's a good thing to do certain things, then that's what you should do. You know, like, I think if you should, you know, if you feel like it's right to give to charity, then that you should do it for yourself and because it makes you feel good. I don't think you should do it because of some sort of self-sacrifice.
Well, I don't know if that's necessarily suggesting self-sacrifice, but I could see how you could interpret it that way. I think that It's certainly not an obligation, but it's probably the right thing to do, right? Like, so that I don't, if you were to, for instance, not be considerate of others in your daily life, then I wouldn't force you to be considerate of others, because that would make, you know, that would just make you resentful and probably.
Sure, but this whole future generations thing strikes me like an environmentalist, like, nonsense.
It could be interpreted that way.
And I feel like it's just, it's almost like a religion. Like, you can be sucked into beliefs about things that are not necessarily accurate, and we'd be taking actions based on those beliefs about, you know, oh, the environment and the world is ending, and let's do, you know, we've got to make sure that, you know, we don't use plastic in our lives because plastic is polluting the ocean. I mean, there's just a whole potential mountain of different slippery slopes here.
Yeah, but at the same time, I mean, look, I guess you can interpret this however you want, right?
Sure.
It's just a generic statement. So, I mean, I can interpret it in the way that, okay, well, yeah, I mean, obviously we're concerned about future generations because we're trying to make the world more free. I mean, like, from our perspective, Jonathan, you and I don't have kids, but plenty of people do who are in our age range and who are within the liberty movement. And I'm sure their motivation is beyond just themselves, that their motivation is to provide a better world for people who come in the future. I mean,
I don't think that anything that's called a commandment it should be so
commanding.
Well, not commanding, but should be so morally relativistic and open to interpretation.
Well, they did call them non-commandments.
Sure.
So it was CNN that termed this the atheist 10 commandments.
Right. But it's too open. I don't like it because it's so open. And I like, there's another thing on the real, on the official 10 commandments, the, you know, the Catholic or whatever Christian 10 commandments, that are, George Carlin does a bit of paring them down.
Okay.
Like, okay, we don't need those. Let's get it down. He gets it down to four real fast, and then he gets it down to one. He's like, I think the only one is like, thou shalt not lie, or thou shalt just be a good person, or something. He's pares it down.
Well, what if we whittled this one down to, I think, what is its essence, and that is to be considerate. I mean, would you disagree with that one?
Sure, I guess we can go there.
You would agree with that?
Be considerate.
Be considerate, right? Yeah. So, in the difference being, this one says it's a responsibility.
Right.
I would just say it's a suggestion.
Yeah.
It's the right way to treat people. Number nine, there is no one right way to live,
true. Before we move on to the you know, I think that the one before this one, the
treat others as you would want them to treat you,
and covers the following one.
It does. Yeah, I think you're right about that. It seems like a variant on that. Number nine, there is no one right way to live. What do you think about that, Johnson? Is there one right way to live?
Well, universally preferable behavior.
What is that, a cult term?
I don't know. What cult would that be?
That's Molyneux, right?
Yes. Yeah. I don't know. You know, I don't know. Is there one way we live? I think not aggressing against other people is the right way to live.
Mm-hmm. That's not a that's when you say non-aggression, that doesn't really specify more. It doesn't really specify your behavior, right? It just specifies what you're not supposed to do.
I mean, the way I don't like the way this is phrased. There is no one right way to live. I think makes it seem like, you know, it's too open. Like, oh, there's tons of right ways to live. It's like, okay, sure, there's not one right way to live. There are many right ways to live, but there are also a whole bunch of wrong ways to live.
Toll-free number tonight.
It doesn't say that.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I think your critique is right on there. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We'll come back with number 10 on the some atheists. Non-commandments, as they're being called. And you can share your thoughts here on this live Christmas Day edition of Free Talk Live. Coming up, the atheist display in Florida is attacked.
Alex Jones here. For the last 2 years, I've been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to design a nutraceutical formulation that has truly life-changing health benefits. So many other formulations out there contain toxic ingredients, synthetic additives, and even GMOs. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure ancient defense for you and your family. Visit InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Hey,
who do you think
you
are?
Excuse me. There is no video and audio allowed
in this office. No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait,
you gotta come.
Now. Wait a minute.
Holy crap. Whoa.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me! What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Juicy Juice, 100% juice, providing a full serving of fruit in every 4 ounces. Visit us at juicyjuice.com. When it comes to nutrition, kids need both fruits and vegetables every day to stay healthy and grow. For the ideal mix, your kid should have at least 1.5 cups of any veggie or 100% veggie juice and 1 cup of any fruit or 100% fruit juice a day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you drinking too much and it's destroying your life? If you're ready to quit drinking, we have a real solution for you that can help you quit drinking within hours. That's right, we can help you quit drinking within hours. It's not magic, it's medical science. At Sober Time, we'll show you how this simple 20-minute outpatient medical procedure will turn off your cravings within hours. Let's face it, if you don't crave a drink, you're not going to drink. And if you don't drink, you won't get drunk. The medication is FDA approved and covered by most major insurance plans. So if you're really ready to stop drinking and get your life back, call Sober Time now for a free consultation. Patients have nearly an 85% success rate. So here's the number. Call right now. 800-659-0267. 800-659-0267. 800-659-0267. 800-659-0267.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can dial toll-free here. We're live, by the way, on this Christmas Day edition of the program with you tonight. You've got Ian.
And Johnson.
Join us online over at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you on the site. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. One of the features.
I was going to say, they're probably thinking, yeah, of course the atheists are doing the show on Christmas.
Except I'm not an atheist.
Do pantheists celebrate Christmas?
Panentheists? I don't know. I mean, certainly there's the winter solstice, which is relatively close by to Christmas. Although I don't know, you know, panentheists are sort of they don't really pick one religion over another. You know, they believe that everything and everything that's not is God. So
what's the difference between a panentheist and a Unitarian Universalist?
I wouldn't be able to tell you. What is a Unitarian Universalist?
It's sort of like a generic religion.
Yeah, I understand
it's like
that.
Kind of Christian. I don't know. I don't know what it is. I don't really know.
Well, there's one right over there on the other street, Johnson. If you want to go and attend one of their services, I actually did go to the Unitarian Church here for one thing that they did, it was during the time of the Occupy,
right,
during Occupy Wall Street. And we had Occupy Keene here in town as well, and the folks at the Unitarian Church invited the occupiers to a church luncheon. And so I went and I attended, and it was an interesting time. And, you know, some of the people were there. They found out that I was a liberty activist or a free stater, and so we got in kind of some heated political conversations where, you know, one guy was like a former doctor who was swearing up and down we need single-payer health care, you know, government-run health care, and got into kind of a discussion with him. Tends to be the folks at the Unitarian Universalists do tend to be more of a lefty kind of a bent.
I wonder whether you'd be bothered if you showed up to the church with a colander on your head.
You know, they seem to be a real accepting group of folks. I mean, right. I you know, when I say heated, it was just not, I mean, it wasn't like shouting or anything like that, but it was a discussion, and right, people had differing viewpoints. But they were pleasant. I mean, they right, weren't rude or anything like that. And so I would say that they would probably maybe, you know, be accepting towards you. I mean, this is the church
that accept Pastafarians.
This is the church that flies a rainbow flag out in right, front of the church, and so I mean, that's kind of their right, indicator that they're a little more open-minded than right, you know, the average church. So, but by all means, Johnson, feel free to attend over there. I know Derek J, I think, was going over there for a little bit for like choir or something. Huh. So, yeah. Anyway, coffee.freetalklive.com. That's where you can go to get a free pound of some of the best coffee out there. If you were listening to our first hour, we actually happen to have a guy call in who was raving about his experience with BuzzBox coffee. He went to coffee.freetalklive.com and hooked up with some coffee. You can get a free pound just by paying the shipping costs, and you can cancel your subscription at any time. So when you get that free pound, you then get on an auto ship program where you can specify how often do you want to receive coffee, what amount do you want to receive coffee. So, you know, they'll send it according to your specifications and, of course, the flavor as well. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com and then know this about BuzzBox. Not only is it great coffee, shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica, but also a portion of the profits go to benefit people in hard parts of the world to live in, you know, people in poverty, giving them microloans through Free Talk Live and Kiva.org. For every 10 listeners that signs up at coffee.freetalklive.com, we can fund one new microloan every single month, which is an amazing amount of microloans. So you can help us out by going to coffee.freetalklive.com.
And I can get a free sample if they're over in the Keene area.
That's right. I guess we have some at the Keene Activist Center. Right?
Well, it's also because 101 Deals serves free coffee.
Do you? And you're serving BuzzBox.
That's right.
That's yeah, sweet. So
that's why. That's one of the main reasons of how I've had the Papua New Guinea medium roast.
That's what you're selling at the store. Or giving it away.
Yeah, giving it away. But they also have the Brazilian dark roast, which is also really good.
So that's your new...
I just tend to prefer lighter roast coffees.
That's the new thrift store here in town run by Liberty Activists, started by Free State Project participants.
That's right.
And there has, even though there's a boycott of the store, it hasn't really affected things.
You wouldn't notice it. I don't know when they're boycotting or how many people, you know.
It's constant. They're always boycotting you.
10 of them? I mean, yeah. I don't know.
That's a good question. So coffee.freetalklive.com, go and check that out. Number 10 here on the list of the atheist, what are being called the atheist 10 commandments, but the atheists were calling them their 10 non-commandments. And again, not all atheists will agree on this list, as we've found here. Johnson is our resident atheist sitting in the show here tonight for the Christmas Day edition as we wrap up this 10 list with number 10, leave the world a better place than you found it. What do you think about that one, John?
I don't know. I mean, on one level, I generally agree with this. And then on another level, it's like, well, you know, is that a responsibility? I don't know.
Well, it's a non-commandment.
It's a suggestion. They're still talking about commandments. Sure.
It's an idea. And there's nothing wrong with leaving a place better than you found it. Right?
Yeah, I generally agree with
passing
that.
Something on to the next generation that is of a better situation than it had been previously. I think that's what we all want to see.
But there's all
happen.
Different belief systems there. Again, I don't like this generalized commandment, because if this requires that you have this belief that this is weird. Like, this is weird because I'm getting into like very bizarre philosophical territory.
Let's do it. It's Christmas Day.
It's Christmas. Why not? But what if...
We can get esoteric here.
So what if this universe... Okay, so let's get really esoteric. Here we go. We're diving in.
All right.
What if this universe doesn't exist for anyone but you?
Can't prove otherwise, that's for sure.
Yeah, you can't. So philosophically, why is there any... If you are dying and you're either moving on to the next plane or passing out of existence entirely or whatever you believe, right?
Yeah.
Why is there any... Why would there be anything to, any incentive to do that, to leave the world a better place than you found it?
Well, you can't prove that that's true, so you should presume otherwise. You should presume that reality exists and that people will continue on in your absence, even though there's no way to really prove that
that's
the case.
But what responsibility do you have to them because you don't exist anymore? You yourself don't exist anymore at that point.
Well, you are obviously out of the world at
that
point.
And why should you serve them over yourself?
I don't think that they're saying that you would have to serve them over yourself. I mean, look, we can have a better world and still enjoy it, right?
Sure.
Like we can still, you know, have the pleasures of life and still, you know, leave a better world.
Also,
and better world doesn't necessarily
mean... What does better mean? Better
for
who?
That's all very subjective, right?
Right.
So by your own
That's
viewpoint.
Why I'm just... I don't like these subjective ones. Better... What does better mean? It's just like the word need. Need is a nonsense word. Need
sure.
What? Who
I
needs?
Mean,
whose needs?
Some people would believe that a better world would be a world in which the government pays for everyone's healthcare system,
right.
But we wouldn't agree with that because we know that, you know, for someone to have a right to healthcare means that the people providing that healthcare are obligated to provide
right.
it and that we wouldn't want to ever obligate someone to do something they haven't agreed to do.
Right.
So therefore, for us,
this is
that
what
wouldn't
I think
be a
of
better
that.
World.
This is what I think of that. Because it's so open-ended like that, again, because it's better. That's a stupid commandment. As an atheist, if you're saying something that's stupid, you're stupid and I don't like you.
Well, there you go. I told you you probably wouldn't agree with all
no,
of them.
No, not all of them. I mean, I just, you know, that one, it's just too open-ended. The open-ended ones are like, okay, you could have spent a little bit more time thinking about this. Aren't you an atheist? You're supposed to be smart.
Now, the Catholics, that's like a variant on Christianity, right? Like, I've never really been to a Catholic church, so I don't know how different it is from
right.
where I grew up. I grew up in a Presbyterian
very creepy
church.
And ritualistic, just like the Episcopalians, actually, which Episcopalians are also, they're Christian.
But the Catholics but have the
it's
Ten Commandments,
Protestant
right?
versus, you know.
The Catholics have the Ten Commandments.
Yes,
correct?
I believe so, yeah.
All right, so apparently this lady who calls herself a Catholic warrior is...
Correct us if we're wrong.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure
likely.
They do. Apparently this lady with the Catholic warrior t-shirt in Florida, she must not have really gotten the message on these Ten Commandments. At least, you know, I can't really probably sit down and recount for you all 10 of them. I mean, maybe I would probably
right.
be able to hit several. But... there's two that are pretty memorable, and that is thou shalt not steal and thou shalt not kill. Like, those
right.
are two basics that, you know, who could really disagree with those two, right? Like,
right.
unless you're a psychopath, you'll agree with those two.
Right.
And apparently, she doesn't agree. Susan Hemrick is her name. She's 54 years old from Tallahassee, which, by the way, this show is on the air in Tallahassee. So she could be listening. She was arrested 2 days before Christmas for knocking down a controversial satanic temple holiday display.
Maybe that's how she heard about the display going up in the first place. Maybe we informed her.
You know, it could be the case, Johnson. We are on the air 7 nights a week in Tallahassee, so it's certainly possible she heard about it from us. Hey, Susan, if you're listening, you want to tell us about your little exploits here. We'd love to hear from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. I've got the...
Somebody's calling her right now.
The news story here actually has her mugshot. It's got video of the act taking place. I'll link over to that on our Facebook, Google+, and Twitter, and we'll come back with more on Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-856-4195. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-856-4195. That's 1-800-856-4195. Call 1-800-856-4195.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, buy a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It is a live Christmas Day edition of the program. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733, and you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com to enjoy the features that are waiting for you there. We're here live. It's Christmas Day, and we're celebrating with Johnson the Atheist. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Now, the Atheist had put up a display. Not, you can't really call it a religious display. It's just their display.
No, was it the Satanists, wasn't it, in Florida?
Oh, you know what? Well, okay, so there's an argument. There's an argument that the Satanic Temple is actually an atheist group.
No, I don't agree.
I would say there's a good argument for it just because the Satanic Temple appears to do nothing but troll other religions.
I guess, but you know.
But anyway, let's get into the story here because we
actually... They only tend to troll Christians.
The story is about a woman named Susan Hemrick. She's from Tallahassee, and we are on the air in Tallahassee. And Johnson, you had suggested that maybe she might be listening to the show or might have listened in the past. And someone is on the line right now claiming that they are Susan. Susan is accused of basically knocking down, although in the video footage, it doesn't appear that she's knocking it down. It appears she's trying to steal the Satanic Temple's holiday display in the state capitol rotunda. Let's go to Susan in Tallahassee. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Susan.
Yes, I remember September 11th, 2014.
So disappointing.
Of course.
This is not Susan. This is James in Arizona.
It's called a joke, as which you two are. But may I speak on Free Talk Live?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Inviting callers to come in. I remember on September 11th, 2014. a co-host making.
I'm glad that you also have nothing to do on Christmas. That's the best to know.
Actually, I celebrated my family. Douchebag.
Sure, you did. You decided to sit down and enjoy the night with Free Talk Live. Thank you.
Sure, you did.
I just want to say thank you.
Are you making fun of your listeners?
You're being very rude, Johnson.
Are you making fun of your listeners?
Just you,
Johnson. No, I wanted to say I remember on September 11, 2014, somebody making a joke about did something special happen this day? So I should like to say I grieve for your mother and your father.
Did something special happen on this day? I think there was supposed to be something was born in a manger or something. What happened? I forgot already. Did something happen on this day? Was there a special event today?
Jesus probably was not actually born on December 25th.
Should I? It's called the celebration of the birth of the Savior. It's not called his birthday. But it is a national holiday because there are hundreds of millions of people that take today seriously. But I'm not talking about you two. But I know that you don't want to have a conversation
with
somebody.
What's your point? What's your point, James?
Open-minded enough to challenge you to think a second time. My point is to call in to disagree with you. And I was trying to speak, but a dude that probably went to McDonald's today if it were open for lunch and dinner.
I actually went to the Chinese buffet today.
Yeah.
It was really good.
I know that's the all-time classic joke. We all love A Christmas Story.
It's not a joke. Anyway, we seriously went to the Chinese buffet.
Johnson,
it was
$12.99. First thing I came out really and said, good. You're a joke.
All right. Well, you obviously don't have anything else to say tonight, so goodbye. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Yeah, I thank Goddess for those wonderful Chinese restaurants for being open on holidays. I mean, Goddess bless them. They're so wonderful. There's nowhere else you can go. I mean, they're the only place that's open. Actually, you know, Denny's was open one year on Thanksgiving. I went to Denny's when I was working in radio.
Say I have to miss Denny's. Denny's.
Do you? You miss Denny's?
I miss Perkins more, but Perkins Denny's wasn't is everywhere. Great.
Anyway,
you don't like Perkins, really?
No, I don't have a problem with Perkins. I mean, there weren't anything to write
Perkins
home about.
Versus Denny's. I'd pick Perkins.
I'd take
time.
Steak and Shake over either of them.
Well, Steak and Shake's not the same type of restaurant.
Let's continue here. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. How disappointing. I was really hoping it would have at least have been someone pretending to be Susan Hemrick from Tallahassee. Instead, it was just James. Who claimed to be Susan.
I got to continue the tangent just for one more second, though. Steak and Shake versus Five Guys, I would take Steak and Shake.
Steak and Shake, any day.
Hands down. Sorry, Five Guys is just greasy.
Five Guys is average at best. Yeah. I mean, they opened up here in Keene a couple of years ago. I went and tried them out. I'm like, oh, okay. That's a burger.
Yeah.
Florida woman arrested just 2 days before Christmas for knocking down a controversial Satanic Temple holiday display. She said she apparently tried removing the display showing an angel falling into the flames of hell with the message "Happy Holidays" from the Satanic Temple on Tuesday. And when Capitol Police told her she couldn't, she began tearing it apart. She was arrested and charged with criminal mischief. The display had been erected as a satire by an atheist. They're claiming the article claims, it's an Associated Press piece appearing in the Daily Mail, claims that they are an atheist group from New York to counter a nativity scene which was taken down the day the Satanic Temple installed theirs. In the past, the Capitol has displayed a Pabst Blue Ribbon Festivus pole, atheist banners, and even a tribute to the Flying Spaghetti Monster. It's just wrong when you remove baby Jesus 2 days before Christmas and put Satan in his place. That just can't happen. I couldn't allow it to happen, said Hemrick, who said she was wearing a shirt that said Catholic Warrior when she arrived at the Capitol. I was, and you can see it there in her mugshot. She says, I was there at the right time and the right moment, and I needed to take a stand against Satan. Atheist groups last year began taking advantage of the Capitol's free speech zone after a Christian group installed a manger scene showing the birth of Jesus. So look, the Christians opened up this Pandora's box. Had the Christians not gone in there and put up their nativity scene, then the people running the state capitol, they could have said no to everyone else. So, you know, there's no one to blame for the Satanic Temple putting up this satanic scene, this display or diorama or whatever you want to call it. There's no one else to blame for this except for the Christians who started it. Because had you just been okay with having your nativity scene on your front lawn,
right,
or on your church lawn, you know, out by the front, the corner, or wherever the traffic goes by, just put it on your own private property. But no, they want to put it on the state property, and so that means it's open season. If somebody wants to show up with the Festivus pole, or the Satanic Temple wants to show up, or the Pastafarians want to show up, they should all be free to do that because free speech, public property. And so, you know, I guess I'm glad to see that the state of Florida didn't stand in the way of this, because certainly in Oklahoma, as we'd seen with the Ten Commandments statue.
I don't know. I'd kind of prefer them to stand in the way of it and just stop having these stupid religious displays.
No, but what I mean was they didn't stand in the way of the Satanic Temple,
right,
or
right,
the Pastafarians, whereas in Oklahoma City,
right,
where the state capitol has a Ten Commandments statue, which has been apparently now driven into and broken, interestingly. But they had this large monolithic kind of statue out there that they were trying to prevent anyone else from putting something up. And so at least in Florida's case, they did allow it.
That's interesting. The Ten Commandments statue was destroyed. I mean,
yes,
it's,
by someone who claimed to be on a mission from Satan.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, typically the a-religious don't do that type of thing, you know, like they're
putting up displays.
No, destroying displays.
Oh.
It tends to be the religious that destroy the anti-religious displays or the alternative religious displays.
I think the
and
dude who destroyed it was like, I please correct me if I'm wrong on this. If you're listening to the show, 855-450-FREE. Obviously, we're just talking here. I don't have the story in front of me, but the dude who ran into it apparently might have been a religious person who was like possessed by Satan or something like that. Yeah, I don't know. I'm sorry, I don't remember the details. We'll see if I can pull it up here in a little bit. But let's talk a little bit more about Susan here, the Catholic warrior who said that it was so wrong to have the satanic display up. She just couldn't allow it to happen, so she violated one of the Ten Commandments by going into the state capitol in front of security guards and everything and literally trying to steal she grabbed the whole display. You know, this video shows it pretty clear. And then as she's ready to head out the door with it, the security guards step in. They manage to sort of grab it from her. And it almost seems like the security guards are the ones who drop it on the floor in the video. And so, I don't know, was that an accident? Or the security guards just see it as their opportunity to F up the satanic display? I don't know about that. But the display last year included a...
Wait, you just gave an either-or option that had the same answer as both sides of it. You're like, did they drop it intentionally, or did they just take their opportunity to drop it? That's sort of the question that you just asked. So,
I don't know what was really going on there.
I think the either-or thing would be, did they drop it intentionally, or did they just accidentally drop it?
Right. The display last year included a 6-foot Festivus pole in tribute to the fake holiday created on Seinfeld that satirizes the commercialism of Christmas, and a display by the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster, which mocks beliefs that a god created the universe and argues instead that the universe was created by a plate of pasta and meatballs. The satanic display was rejected as grossly offensive last year, but this year, following threats of legal action from the Americans United for Separation of Church and State, the State Department of Management Services gave its approval. We'll continue here in moments with the Catholic warrior story, this lady who decided she was going to take matters into her own hands and put a stop to the Satanic Temple. Hour 3 is coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great.
realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Christmas Eve, Wednesday, December 24th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,177, silver around $15.78, and Bitcoin is trading around $334.28. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Extreme weather. From droughts lasting for weeks and torrential rainstorms robbing the country of vital crops for food, to snowstorms of 70 inches plus stopping cities in their tracks. Supporting your family through these difficult times is what eFoods Direct does. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, a Jacoby, Massachusetts man is facing charges after posting "put wings on pigs" to Facebook, according to police. Charlie DeRosa will be summoned to court for threat to commit a crime. Police will file a complaint in court seeking a show cause hearing. If the court determines the complaint is valid, a trial will be scheduled. On Saturday, two New York police officers were killed by a gunman while sitting in their police cruiser. The suspect, who then killed himself, had posted, "I'm putting wings on pigs today," on social media. Jacoby police posted on their Facebook page that the alleged threat by DeRosa was taken seriously because of the events of the past few days. The Interview was put back into theaters Tuesday when Sony Pictures Entertainment announced a limited Christmas Day theatrical release for the comedy that provoked an international incident with North Korea and outrage over its canceled release. Sony Entertainment CEO Michael Lynton said the James Franco, Seth Rogen North Korea farce will be in a number of theaters beginning on Thursday. He said Sony is also continuing its efforts to release the film on more platforms and in more theaters. Today's broadcast of the Liberty Beat is made possible by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. Support for the Liberty Beat also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, December 24th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On December 6th, over 600 citizens marched in Boulder, Colorado, demanding that police stop shooting and killing unarmed African Americans. The protest came in response to the shooting in Ferguson, Missouri, and many others like it that have happened around the country. But who organized the protest? It was a full-time activist who had a financial backer, Alexis Neely. Without Neely, he would have not been able to dedicate 60 to 80 hours a week to organizing. Because of Neely's sponsorship, he could focus on activism. Neely believes in putting her money where her heart is. And for her, that means sponsoring people doing good in the world. Now, Neely is using business to help people put their money where their heart is. Right now, Neely is offering a free training to those who want to get in the right relationship with money and use it to make the world a better place. Her free training is available right now online at moneymap.tv. For as often as Democrats attack the conservative billionaires Charles and David Koch for their heavy spending on politics, it's actually the liberal-minded who shelled out the most cash on the just-completed midterm elections. At least, that is among those groups that must disclose what they raise and spend. That word comes in a special report from the Associated Press. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, visit libertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, December 24th, 2014, Christmas Eve. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
On May 22, 1992, beloved talk show host Johnny Carson ended his 30-year run of hosting The Tonight Show with a farewell episode that included special guests Saddam Hussein, KKK Grand Wizard Virgil E. Griffin, and a musical performance by the Flag. On May 24, 1883, the Brooklyn Bridge opened, providing New Yorkers with a more efficient way of killing themselves and escaping their trash-ridden excrement cake city. The monument's historic opening was marked by hundreds of people jumping 275 feet to their deaths in order to avoid waking up every morning with the smell of horse shit filling their nostrils.
Before the Brooklyn Bridge, there were very few ways for New Yorkers to free themselves from the cesspool in which they lived. One method was to tie cinder blocks on their legs and walk into the Hudson River. But of course, the banks of the Hudson were so brimming with garbage and raw sewage that the putrid stench would drive back even the most desperate suicide seeker.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
And Johnson.
And please, you can also join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. So, Johnson is our, I guess, our atheist for the night. We had
sure.
Chris Cantwell on the show last night. He is also an atheist. So it's kind of like, it's kind of been an atheist Christmas here on Free Talk Live. Although I am not an atheist. I'm a panentheist. At one time in my life, I was an atheist. So I can definitely empathize with them. And right now, the atheists are under attack. Or at least in Tallahassee at the Florida State Capitol in the Rotunda.
Well, the Satanists are under attack.
Good point. Thanks for keeping on clarifying that for me, Johnson, because what's throwing me off is this article over at the Daily Mail is referring to the Satanic Temple as a group of atheists.
Yeah, which is not, I mean, the group of atheists would be more likely, you'd be more likely to be referring to the spaghetti monster display, which is also there.
It has been in the past. I don't know if the spaghetti monster was represented, or the if there was a representation of spaghetti flying spaghetti monster this year.
Okay,
but it has definitely been there in the past, as well as a Pabst Blue Ribbon Festivus pole and atheist banners. But this, yeah,
Pabst, they had a PBR Festivus pole.
There's actually
does
a picture
that mean
of
that
it
the
here.
Can was made out of the pole was made out of the cans, or
it appears as though it was a pole with cans placed over top. I'm not real sure though, because. Yeah, that's what it looks like here. There is actually a picture of the Pabst Blue Ribbon Festivus pole, and it does appear as though the man in the picture is setting a can of Pabst Blue Ribbon on the very top of the pole, so you can sort of see the pole sticking out from I guess underneath all of the other cans that have already been placed on it. So I'll put this link up on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter. You can take a look at some of the photos of what the rotunda looks like here. But the Satanic Temple had come in with their own display. And it says, Happy Holidays from the Satanic Temple. And there's some sort of satanic-looking pentagram symbol there. And then there's an angel that is falling into flames, sort of a diorama of that. A couple of signs there.
Be Satan, probably, in most
Presumably that would be Lucifer. Yep, falling into the fires of hell. There's a couple of quotes surrounding it, but I can't read them in the photograph here in the story. But Susan Hemrick, she's 54 years old. She's been charged with criminal mischief for trying to tear down the atheist display. And if you watch the video on this this page, it makes it pretty clear that she took the display. She didn't just like go right. and grab the angel and like tear it down or whatever. She grabbed the entire diorama and attempted to leave the state capitol with it. She was stopped at the door by security. She says, it's just wrong when you remove baby Jesus 2 days before Christmas and put Satan in his place. Now, it's not explained why it is that the Christian nativity scene was removed at any point. That doesn't really make sense to me.
I asked that question when we talked about it before, if you remember.
Yeah.
They said that they would remove the others. I'm like, what?
I don't understand. Maybe the way they did it was they had certain days, like certain ranges in which each display could exist. Why not just allow them all at the same time? I don't know. Anyway, atheist groups last year began taking advantage of the Capitol's free speech zone, talking about how they put up the flying spaghetti monster, etc. The Satanic Temple was originally rejected last year, but this year they were under threat from the Americans United for Separation of Church and State, and so the state did go ahead and give its approval. John Porgel, the regional director of the American Atheists, said this about it, quote, the angel's dead. When he arrived at the Capitol to see the angel figurine lying alone on a table, he says, quote, we've been tolerant of their display. We didn't like it, but we tolerated it. You see what they did to our display. So there you go, Johnson. He is the head of the American Atheists in the region, and he is a member, apparently, of the Satanic Temple.
Yeah, and it's unfair what he's doing there, too.
What do you mean?
Saying they, what they did to our display. No, it's what she did to your
Good
display.
Point. Yeah, certainly not all Christians would have supported what the Catholic warrior, the self-professed Catholic warrior Susan Hemrick did here in clearly violating the thou shalt not steal commandment in order to walk off with the Satanic Temple display. The Satanic Temple, according to the Daily Mail, Johnson, is a satirical group created by atheists that opposes religious displays and activity on government property and public schools. Porgel, who again is the head of the American Atheists, said he wasn't surprised someone had damaged the display, which he had installed in the Capitol just 1 day earlier. He says, I was really surprised that it took this long. I was really expecting it to be damaged because of the religious part of our society. The same group asked to distribute satanic coloring books in Orlando high schools after a Christian group was allowed to distribute Bibles. The school district is now reconsidering its policy. Porgel said he plans to leave the display in its damaged state as a sign of what the religious right's idea of tolerance is. Pam Olson, who organized the manger display, says she doesn't approve of the attack. She said, I'm actually very sad that she felt motivated to do that. I do not like the display. I think it's rude, and it's sad that he put it up to protest the nativity that means so much to millions of people. However, I don't think anyone should ever vandalize anything. Free speech is free speech, whether we like it or not.
Right.
And she's obviously absolutely right about that. Although, I don't know if the atheists or the Satanic Temple, maybe there are some actual Satanists within the Satanic Temple, but it doesn't seem like the majority of them are. That the Satanic Temple was putting it up to protest the nativity scene. I think they were just putting it up to express themselves in a public space.
Right.
Because the nativity scene is allowed, so should other scenes or whatever, you know, whatever message it is that they want to put up there. If you're going to allow one, you have to allow all of them. That doesn't mean the others are protesting the existence of the nativity scene.
Right.
Going on here with the Daily Mail piece, Ms. Hemrick says she has no criminal record and she hasn't even had a speeding ticket in more than 15 years and she had only one regret about Tuesday's incident.
Hard to go really fast when you're carrying something that large.
She said, I just yanked that little devil off the fishing line. I should have just done a better job and finished it off for good. The string suspending the angel was broken when the exhibit was knocked over, so John Portugal placed the Porgel placed the angel upright amid the paper flames. She's in hell now, Porgel said of the angel. They've actually caused her to go to hell. I don't know why they're saying her. Maybe the angel is not Lucifer, Johnson. So there you go. That's the latest on the Satanic Temple display in Florida. It has been decimated by one Catholic warrior. You're welcome to share your thoughts here tonight with us at 855-450-FREE. And that's not the only nativity scene-related news. There's also a zombie nativity scene that is making headlines.
Okay.
In Sycamore Township, Ohio. Where this week, a local government in the town had, just outside of Cincinnati, ordered a man to remove his zombie nativity scene that he built on his own property.
Right.
We'll tell you more about that here in moments. Huh. Al is with us first, listening in Bangor, Maine. Al, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Johnson. Welcome.
This talk of freedom, which you have in common with the atheist, is really the forces of darkness. And you're on this side of the protesters now as they're marching in the street. Some of them saying that we should kill the cops, these devils.
Well, I'm not on the side of that.
No, neither am I.
And say, let's cancel Christmas. We
nope,
see the,
nope,
the
I'm
rioters.
Not,
so you're
I'm
not
going
to respond to that? You're just going to keep plowing through? Or
yeah,
you're
I'd like
have
to
a conversation?
Yeah, can we have a conversation, Al? Because you're making accusations that aren't true. First of all, I don't support killing cops. Well, I do support protests. Oh, I'm sorry. It sounded like you said that.
I support the anti-police protests because your heart is far from God. You've gone over to the dark side.
So killing innocent people is what being close to God is? Is that what you're saying? Because the reason why most people who support these anti-police protests are because they don't like it when police kill innocent people. So what you're trying to say is that you should be close to God by supporting the police killing innocent people. Is that what you're saying? I'm just trying to understand you.
The devil is a father of lies, and when you say that Michael Brown was innocent, that's
no,
a
no.
Lie.
I'm talking about
you know.
No, no. I'm
that.
Talking about Eric Garner.
Eric Garner was innocent.
Yes,
how
absolutely.
So?
How
Eric Garner
so?
Was
he broke up. No, he wasn't selling cigarettes. If you watch the full video, he broke up a street fight.
Yeah, but
no,
he
wasn't a career criminal.
He had sold cigarettes, Johnson, so therefore he deserved to be choked to death.
Oh, okay. In the
Jesus
past.
Loves it when you choke people to death.
He was a career criminal.
No, he wasn't.
And he brought.
No, he was a family man who was trying to make a few extra bucks. Look, hang on, Al. I'll bring you back, and because you're putting words in our mouth, and I don't think it's very fair, but I'll give you a chance to continue here in a moment. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was
kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free at 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you. Over at freetalklive.com, you can actually help support the show in a number of different ways. But one of the easiest ways to do it is just to share Free Talk Live. Whatever episode that you've enjoyed recently, maybe within the last week, pick that episode, copy the link over, and share it on your Facebook page or Twitter or wherever it is you hang out online. We sure would appreciate your efforts. So once again, go to freetalklive.com and enjoy. As we go back to Al, he's in Bangor. And Al, you're back on Free Talk Live. I think that you were unfairly putting words in our mouths earlier, like suggesting that, you know, we might support killing police, which definitely we don't support that. But go ahead. What was the point you were trying to make? You were saying something about, like, we're on the dark side, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, the whole left, the essence of libertarianism, you can see it in the French Revolution and the American Revolution, is to overemphasize freedom in opposition to duty. Policeman represents duty, honor, courage, God, country. Eric Garner represented dope, dirtiness, laziness. So he wasn't as good as a police officer. You're making a generalization.
Eric Garner represented dope. What do you mean by that?
Well, he was a dope user.
How do you know that?
Long criminal
yeah,
history.
That's one of the...
He wasn't as good. You have to make a distinction in people between good behavior and bad behavior.
Is it a good thing to squeeze the life out of someone because they've used pot or dope or whatever?
It was their duty to squeeze the life out of him because he used marijuana.
When you make the generalization, they did a good thing by trying to enforce the law when they took him down.
Because he was a pot smoker, so really they should have just, I mean, they should have just flat out executed him a long time ago is what you
No,
right?
Because he was resisting the law. And this is
actually, he wasn't. You can watch the video of it. He didn't resist
it's
arrest.
It's a spirit of lawlessness which you're spreading. You're making generalization that the police are bad. All right, have you heard of the Rolling Stones?
No, I think that murderers are bad, not police. I think murderers are bad.
The song Sympathy for the Devil, you have an atheist there. You're saying it's a good thing to put...
I'm not a Satanist, sir. I think you have that confused.
At Christmas
I don't believe in the devil. I think that's a ridiculous concept.
Was it a good thing that they put that in the Florida State House?
Well, of course. I mean, free speech, right? Don't you agree with free speech?
Of course it's a good thing. You put freedom above God's law. And
wait, doesn't God love freedom?
The song... No, God doesn't love freedom.
No?
What are you talking about?
What a crappy God. I mean, why wouldn't your God love freedom?
There you go with the blasphemy again.
Why? Wait a minute. Why would your God not love freedom? What's wrong with freedom? Is that like a satanic thing to be free?
Yes.
Is that right? Huh. That's the first time I've heard that claim.
As you know, the essence of libertarianism, 1776, the American Revolution, equality, individual rights, the doctrine is do as thou wilt. And because of that philosophy, America is falling apart. We have to honor.
That's not the libertarian doctrine. Libertarian viewpoint is to do as you wilt as long as you do no harm.
I want to thank you. Thank you so much. I am so glad. I'm really glad that there are guys out there like this that exist. Because people like this guy that are responsible for me like becoming an atheist. It's people exactly like this guy who help people to wake up and realize, like, this belief system is nonsense. Nonsense. God hates freedom. I mean, that's one of the things that just helps people to go, wow, I don't want to be religious, and I don't want to have anything to do with anyone who is.
I see where you're coming from there.
Well, I appreciate you preaching this, and I would really, I would hope that you would really go on to tell more people.
Give him a donation.
I know,
so
seriously,
he can expand his preaching.
Please do, because I mean, I appreciate when people like preach about duty and how religion, you know, God hates freedom and you can't do anything with your life and, you know, smoking marijuana means that you should be killed.
Hey,
wonderful.
Do you think that the cops who kill people are going to go to heaven?
If a police officer, if it's a justifiable homicide, it doesn't matter. It is your faith in God and your faith in Jesus that gets you into heaven, not your good deeds or your bad deeds.
So what you're saying is, you can
faith,
kill
not
people.
Not good deeds or bad deeds. I love people that believe like this.
I just want to understand. I mean, look, what you're saying is, and are you a Christian? You're a Christian, right?
Yes.
So what you're saying is that you can just violate the Ten Commandments as a cop, as long as it's justifiable, as long as you have a good reason for murdering someone, you can take the life of another human being and still make it to heaven?
You cannot. There's something called a justifiable homicide. Mm-hmm. If a person comes at a police officer with a gun,
what's that have to do with the Ten Commandments, though? Because I'm pretty sure in the Ten Commandments it just says, thou shalt not kill. It doesn't say, thou shalt not kill, except in the circumstances of a justifiable homicide.
You can violate any commandment as long as it's justifiable and as long as God will give you forgiveness because you've accepted Jesus into your heart. So you can get forgiveness for anything as long as you've accepted Jesus. The only real crime in Christianity, for the most part, is blaspheming. Yeah. Blaspheming the Holy Spirit and denying and saying, the Holy Spirit does not exist. Jesus isn't real.
I would like to deny the Holy Spirit because, look, I don't deny God. I mean, I'm a panentheist. I believe in the idea of, you know, that the fact that everything is connected and that we're all that essentially everything is God. That's my belief system. But that doesn't mean that I believe in a daddy God in the sky with a set of arbitrary rules.
I can tell both of you in your voice that you know God is real. You're laughing. That's embarrassed laughter.
No. I'm laughing at you, not with you.
Yeah, John's just laughing at you.
You will not believe in him because of your sin.
Why is there only one God?
Oh, they believe in three gods, the Christians.
That's logic.
That's Catholics.
Proof of God.
No, do all Christians believe in three gods? Is there three gods? Is it the Father, Son, the Holy Ghost?
They believe in it's.
I can explain that to you.
All right, go quickly.
There is only one God because the question arises, who created God? If there is another God, he cannot be God. There must be one who created the universe, not a multiplicity, because if there's a multiplicity.
But what about the Holy Ghost and the, you know, Jesus? Aren't they also God in the Christian belief system?
There are three persons in the Trinity. And God the Father, Jesus, who is a manifestation of the nature of God, who taught us that we are children of God, and that God is a merciful Father. He's a revelation.
Was that cop doing God's work when he mercifully strangled that man to death, Eric Garner?
He was the police do God's work. mm-hmm. because God has
Was it
given
God's work when the cops shot the gas grenade or whatever it was into a baby's crib?
God is the author of all laws.
And what about the military? Are they also doing God's work?
They absolutely are.
You're so sick, Al. You're so sick. You don't even realize that you don't even follow your own belief system, and I thank you for the call tonight.
The Flying Spaghetti Monster created God to fool people into believing in a false deity.
Toll-free number tonight is
to test their faith.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Thou shalt not kill unless you're the police or the military. Then it's totally fine. It's Free Talk Live.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Everyone in Pennington is talking about it. Something smells like weed in that back part of the library. Head librarian Cookie Stevens and library volunteers Margaret Mosier and Gail Fredericks were in the middle of discussing the upcoming used book Saleganza when they smelled something strange.
So Saleganza smelled marijuana somewhere, and we're like shocked.
Yeah.
And so Doug goes, do you smell it?
Without any way to confirm that the smell was indeed weed, Cookie Stevens called her husband Sheriff Stevens, who called in local ceramics teacher Dutch Gibbs, who lived in Seattle for a few months in the 70s.
Yeah, that's weed.
Sheriff Stevens has begun compiling a list of potential suspects, including that boy Lance, who has girl hair and hangs out down by the quarry, Greg Fromke, who was spotted this evening really going to town on some potato skins at Steaky Jake's Steakhouse, and Mr. Thompson. Luckily, one young reading enthusiast seemed unperturbed by the illicit smell.
Yeah, I don't smell anything. I really, really, really love the library.
The weed smell comes on the heels of last month's discovery of a gigantic pair of women's underpants in the children's fiction section. According to Stevens, that case remains open as well.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial in here, toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Yes, that's right. Johnson and I, we're on the dark side. The people who are on the side of light are the ones who support squeezing the life out of other human beings and setting houses on fire.
Well, they're doing justice because they're doing their duty to God.
It's so so twisted. That's at least the summary of our last
call. You can't be an atheist and be a police officer, apparently.
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. If you care about online privacy, you really need Pro XPN, and you can go and get it for free for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices over at proxpn.com/FTL. It encrypts your internet connection, meaning your internet service provider will no longer be able to have any idea what you're doing online. Right now, they're probably logging the websites that you visit, the search terms that you enter, and they may be keeping those logs for up to 5 years. You can put a stop to it by downloading the ProXPN software, getting it installed. It only takes a moment over at proxpn.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, and the ability to privately torrent as well as get past regionally blocked websites, you can upgrade for 50% off of the annual account price by using code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live and the number 50 as in 50% off. By the way, that savings is valid for the lifetime of the account. So you continue to get that 50% off every year thereafter. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, use code FTL50. It's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. You have nothing to lose but your privacy. And ProXPN, by the way, does not keep records of your online habits. So go to proxpn.com/FTL as we go to your calls and thoughts here. We go first to John, listening in Minnesota to WNMT. Hey, John.
Yes, hello.
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
You have quite an interesting discussion tonight.
Thanks.
I believe that man has his strongest power is the power of choice, and he should make up his own mind. And the people witnessing with just their words, it's better to witness with someone's action. The way they live speaks louder than what they say.
But I thought the last caller said that the only thing that matters is faith. It doesn't matter what you actually do.
Well, faith and works go together. If you don't, if you pray for something to happen, if you don't act upon it, you don't show good faith. You know, you got to act upon it too.
Okay. Anything else you want to clarify tonight, John?
That's it.
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you.
Let's
talk to Bill. He's in Massachusetts. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Bill.
Hey, Ian.
Hey.
I wanted to just remind people of where their line in the sand may be, because I have three specific lines in the sand where I will, initiate defensive force. So I wanted people to think about where their line in the sand was with all of these events happening in current events and whatnot. But anyway,
what kind of line in the sand? I mean, give us an example of what that means.
Well, Chris Cantwell has been bringing up a lot of, you know, when do you defend yourself, and when is it, you know, proper to defend yourself and whatnot. And I have three lines in the sand that, you know, just come closer and closer every day, and they kind of worry me a little bit. Even this call worries me a little bit, you know, being calling and talking about it. But at the same time, it's part of my core being. Anyways,
do you have any lines of sand that you can actually share?
Yes. Gun confiscation on a wholesale basis, not on a one-by-one individual basis. Mm-hmm. It's based on probable cause.
So you're one of these.
Just an outright gun ban is one.
So you're one of the folks who say, you know, essentially you come to take my gun, you get it bullet first.
Definitely.
Can you legally own a gun in Massachusetts? It seems to be one of the worst places for that.
I do, and I've attended gun church with the Free Staters.
Oh, right on. Very cool.
Right up in there.
Well, I appreciate the idea of a line in the sand. I just feel like, you know, by the time they cross that line, it could be very, very difficult for you to provide, you know, violent resistance.
No, I exercise my Second Amendment here in Massachusetts. You know, people say that Massachusetts has really bad gun laws, but, you know, I'm very vocal against government and whatnot, and I have a battle rifle and a pistol and a shotgun. just like everyone else, they're all mass compliant, so they just have extra safety features on them. That's about it. And stuff that makes them louder and brighter so that they can't be hidden when you shoot them. That's about it. So really, Massachusetts, you can have pre-ban magazines and whatnot. So they're able to keep me pacified with enough gun rights to not immediately move to New Hampshire or Vermont, which I'm on the border of now. You know, I'm on the border of those two states, so I can just quickly jump over the line on either one. Anyways, the second one, which I had to face in 2010, is forced inoculations. They were going to do National Guard forced inoculations in 2010, and I went right to the Board of Health person here in charge of FEMA through Homeland Security, who I know, who actually babysat my son for a partial summer. He now is our local FEMA guy, and I went to his place, and I talked to him, and I said, look, if you guys come to my door with the National Guard and syringes for the H1N1, you will be also injected with heavy metals as well. So just remember that heavy metals, I'm going to inject you with heavy metals. And my third one, which is getting very, very close, which was just in the media today, brought up in the state of Oregon, is taxed by the mile by the government in my motor vehicle or my transport car or automobile or pickup truck. I'm Silverado.
Is that something really worth dying over?
If they're going to charge me by the mile to exercise my free right to travel, then if they're going to charge me by the mile on that, that is a line in the sand that I will forcefully resist.
You're going to
start
shooting.
They do that right now in New York, so you've never driven through New York. Because they have a thing where you go through one toll, and they give you a ticket, and then you go to the next toll, and that's when they collect your money.
Yeah, that's true. I've seen those. They do that in other places.
No, that's a toll road, and that's actually different than having a tracking device like an EasyPass. If EasyPass becomes mandatory, or they start using plate recognition cameras to log my miles...
Bill, I mean, while I can appreciate...
When I get my plates renewed, I'm all done with civil...
Bill, I can appreciate where you're coming from, but I mean, really, is that one worth dying over? Because you know, if you...
It really is. It really is.
But don't you have kids?
I'm a race driver. I'm a local champion at Keene's Racetrack.
Okay.
I literally, my whole being has been... I mean, when I strap a vehicle onto my body, it's an extension of my fingertips.
But Bill, don't you have kids? I mean, you've got a son, right?
I do.
Yeah, I mean, you'd essentially
and that privilege, I have to hand that privilege over to him. It's not my responsibility or my, I can't hand that over. It's not mine to give away. It's mine to protect for him with my life if necessary.
Bill, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I mean, I don't agree that violence solves problems, but I also... You know, I can't say I blame somebody for having a point at which they will be pushed over the brink. I mean, everybody has it, or at least most people have it. I just don't think that it's very effective. I don't think that, you know, okay, so they put a mileage tax in and then Bill goes and starts shooting some Department of Motor Vehicles bureaucrats or whatever what he would do after that. And then, you know, Bill's going to die as a result. And now his son's not going to have a father. I mean, that's not going to make his life better.
And I said this on the air years and years and years ago, my line in the sand is a draft. You know, that I had a line in the sand and that it's the draft. But now I really wonder, is that time for violence or just time to leave?
Or how about time for non-cooperation? How about time for not going to the draft and, you know, not participating in it and, you know, recording video?
Yeah, but there's a difference between, you know, okay, not participating in the draft and, okay, what if they come to draft you? I mean, I'm over the age where I'd be drafted now, but...
Well, they're not going to be able to force you to hold a gun in your hands, and they're not going to be able to force you to, you know, forcing you to get on a cargo jet and be taken over to Iraq and then having a gun put in your hand. This is all very unlikely if you are
a
non-cooperative.
Sure, but it could happen, and it's like...
They'll put you in a prison cell, Johnson. They're not going to... They can't force you to fight.
Right.
They're either going to put you in a prison cell or they'll execute you, one or the other.
Right.
So, the toll-free number is 855-453.
Do you want to just let yourself be executed, or do you fight back?
I might just shoot myself before they can do something to me. At least then they can't paint me as, you know, some crazy cop killer or whatever. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up. This is Free Talk Live.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Chuck Woolery here. You know, I've talked before about Australian Dream, the effective arthritis pain relief cream that doesn't burn, isn't greasy, and has no odor. Now there's new Australian Dream back pain cream with all those great benefits. But this penetrating formula can help relieve your simple back pain. And it's backed by an empty jar guarantee. If you're not satisfied, you can send back the empty jar for a full refund. But I don't think you will, because Australian Dream really works. Don't let back pain ruin your day. Get Australian Dream back pain cream at Walgreens.
It's that time of year again, and you know what that means. Cold and flu season. But don't worry. HerbalHealer.com has you and your loved ones covered with our safe and natural products. Cold and flu fighters like beta-glucans, olive leaf antiviral capsules, grapefruit seed extract, HHA 4-herb capsules, elderberry power, and respirate. And don't forget about oregacillin for the lungs, normally $34.95, on sale now for only $25. Vitamin D3, 120-count soft gels, only $9. Whole body and homeopathic detoxes for the lungs, kidneys, liver, lymph, and brain, normally $26.95, now just $20. HerbalHealer.com also offers correspondence courses to teach you how to handle your health naturally. And as always, new customers get a free 128-page catalog with your order. Visit HerbalHealer.com and click the Winter Specials button to save on our natural cold and flu-fighting products. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can dial toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features there. We'll continue with live programming throughout the holidays every single day. We are here, and we'll take your calls. Toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. Join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. We continue with your calls and thoughts, and then if we get the chance, which I don't know if we will, but if we get the chance, we'll talk about the zombie nativity scene here in a little bit with Ian and Johnson behind the mics here tonight. Let's go first to your calls and thoughts. We've got Kurt in Albuquerque listening to Kiva. Hey, Kurt.
Hello. Hi.
Hey,
welcome. First time I've heard your show.
Thanks.
Pretty cool. Yeah, I'm a
I guess there's such a category. I think I'm an atheist, and I'm a conservative right winger. I think there's about six of us in the nation, I think. we do exist. My impression is that, you know, a lot of atheists are pretty left wing often, and that's fine. I think a lot of atheists, they kind of bug me a little bit. I don't care about creches.
Can I ask you a question real quick? Have you heard of anarcho-capitalism?
Yes.
What do you think of it?
It's more intriguing every day.
Okay, fantastic.
I think I know what you're saying is that people, I think I heard one of the Pauls say this. It's like, knock yourself out. If you like socialism, do it. You know, it's voluntary. What's this notion that we have to have this entire country run one way?
Right.
If we let things kind of devolve a little bit, let things, you know, to run this country, this diverse country that's large in one way, I just never get that.
Yeah.
You know, the countries that are socialist are very small and homogenous. They work for Norway, but it would never work for us. And I think anarcho-capitalism is like, look, just whatever economic arrangements you want, do it. You know, just don't have it forced upon the 320 million of it. I think that's what it means.
Yeah, you're pretty close.
It kind of means that, but the problem with anarcho-capitalism is it's got two really bad words mixed together, anarchist and capitalism. Because people don't understand what those things mean, and I think when you
Ian
say...
Ian is a word statist.
Look, words have meanings. Words have meanings.
Right, which is why they should be defended.
I'm not here to defend the term capitalism.
No,
and
you're here
the word
to destroy
capitalism.
Them.
The word capitalism.
You're here to
does
put them
not,
in jail and arrest these words for being bad.
The word capitalism does not include.
Let
what,
the words be free,
Kurt
man.
Was just saying what Kurt was saying was that he, you know, to him, anarcho-capitalism means anybody can try any kind of system they want, so long as it's voluntary. Not necessarily. If the word capitalism is in the term, then that suggests that socialism would not be okay.
No,
or
it doesn't.
Communism would not be okay.
No, it doesn't. Not at all. That's what he said was absolutely accurate of what anarcho-capitalists believe. Absolutely.
I know what they believe. I'm telling you, having the word capitalism in there suggests that this would not be a truly free place in which you would be able to try communism. If it's a anarcho-capitalist place, the communists might not feel very welcome, would they? But if it's
a free market,
then it's open to anybody to do anything they want so long as it's voluntary. If it's voluntarist or voluntarist, then that doesn't say, well, it has to be capitalist.
Real capitalists believe in the free market. He didn't say anarcho-corporatism.
I understand that, Johnson. Can you at least acknowledge how using the term capitalism in your belief system to describe what you want to see happen, supposedly an open free market, might actually make it sound like other things besides capitalism, other organization, you know, economic forms of organization like communism would not be welcome. Would you want to join an anarcho-communist society? Because what the communists were telling you, hey, we'll let you do whatever you want.
Well, here, the thing is I think that the word free market is just as tainted to the people who don't believe in capitalism.
Maybe so. How about voluntarism?
I don't know.
I don't
know. Probably it's starting. It's getting there. It's climbing slowly.
Go ahead, Kurt.
Yeah.
Well, I think anarchists believe just kind of do what you want and have the arrangement, you know, that you want. Maybe you're just describing take the capitalist out and just say anarchism. That may be it. But
well, I think that's preferable. I also think anarchism has a connotation towards violence and bomb throwing, which obviously it shouldn't.
Destroy the hierarchies.
Yeah.
So right.
I don't use the terms
but
myself.
I tell these creche businesses and zombies. I think I know what kind of these left wing atheist types. They're trying to mock people. I don't like to mock people's belief system. I don't. But I think the government should be neutral. And I tell these religious folks, look, you can't have a religious creche or manger scene. You can't deny the atheists, the pagans, the Wiccans. That's the thing. So the answer is do nothing. Be neutral. I do think the government, which is left-wing now, is kind of anti-religion. And I don't – these lawsuits against crosses, oh, my God, I think it's such much ado about nothing. And it hurts the atheist cause. I don't give a rat about a symbol. I just don't believe in it. But I think on the I'm actually a reluctant defender of the religious because I just don't care. You know, I mean, I know some left wingers who take a marker and cut and and mark out In God We Trust. I think Jesus, you're such a pain in the ass. I mean, come on. And
yeah, that's a time consuming
thing
to do.
I think we'd be better if we just were more polite about it. Well, that's polite. I love Hitchens and those guys when 9/11 happened, they really went for the religious connection between the bombings and a religion that's called Islam, you know. And I'm for those guys. They were very fearless about what they did. But I think the government should be neutral, you know, just to stand above it all. And again, I tell these religious people, knock it off with the mangers, for God's sake. I mean, it's not.
Well, there's nothing wrong. Just to clarify, there's nothing wrong with them having a manger on their church property or on their own front lawn. But it's when they put it on state property is when they open the Pandora's box.
I mean, it's easy, really. And then all the other crazies come out, the zombies, which is funny. I know what they're doing, and the Satanists and stuff. And it just gives them just neutral, nothing, you know. I mean,
yeah, if they were smart, they'd leave it alone, because if what the Christians want is to not promote Satanism, then they shouldn't put their nativity scene in the state capitol.
Correct.
Because it allows for the Satanists to get all this news media coverage and all that. Kurt, thanks for the call tonight. Welcome to the show.
Yep.
We're relatively new there on Kiva in Albuquerque, but you'll be hearing us again.
On Sundays on which days?
They're taking us all week long there, and I think they're grabbing us on weekends now as well there. Thank you, Kurt, for your call tonight.
You know,
I appreciate it.
As he was saying that, and as I was crossing out In God We Trust on this 20, because I thought it was amusing to do so as he was talking about it, I noticed something about the design of this. Right above the word God and above the In God We Trust in this design. So a designer probably consciously did this. The photograph, the White House is there. So they're saying In God We Trust right in the White House, right? Mm. But above the word God is the flag and the word states.
Ooh.
Are above God in the design. I just find that kind of interesting. It's like actually like the In God We Trust isn't at the
top. That's an interesting observation.
The United States of America and the word specifically states and the flag is actually both above the word God. I find that really interesting.
Yeah, well, most things are done for a reason when it comes to designing art like that. Joe is listening in Los Angeles. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Joe.
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air on Christmas with Free Talk Live.
Yeah. I've called in before, and I listen every once in a while. And whenever the conversation seems to turn to Christianity, I find myself kind of like dialing in and wanting to participate. I wanted to take issue with the whole idea of pantheism, number one. And then the other thing was when I was listening to your colleague who... When you were talking to the guy talking about the devil or whatever, and
dark side,
and how he thought the devil, and how but the devil was such a ridiculous concept. I take issue with those two things, and because number one, I don't think the devil is a ridiculous concept. I think it's a very real reality, and the whole idea of pantheism sort of leaves you basically with nothing to work with.
What about the devil is real? Like a little red guy? How like
seems like a very man-made creation to me.
Well, no, I don't see it like that. I see it as like basically everything lines up scripturally. So if you look at how you know the Bible, people turn to the Bible and say, "Why would this be true?" And they say, "Well, because it foretells the future, and God intentionally." Prophesied in order to prove himself, right? And so when you look at how that the truth of the book of Revelation and how that all lines up with what's going on now and living in this age of deception, and you're seeing and you're seeing that reinforced by this new age philosophy that is permeating everything.
I really do wish we had more time to talk to you about this, Joe, but we are out of it for tonight. Call us back on another night. I may be taking tomorrow night off, but we'll still have live content with Daryl in the studio tomorrow night. Thanks, Joe, for your call, and happy to have that conversation at a later time, but we can't do it in 10 seconds. It's been Ian here with you.
And Johnson.
See you tomorrow online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
Phone records, financial and location data, Prism, Tempora, X-Keyscore, Boundless Informant. Hey, y'all, Scott Horton here for offnow.org. Now, here's the deal. Due to the Snowden revelations, we have a great opportunity for a short period of time to get some real rollback of the national surveillance state.
Now, they're already trying to tire us by introducing fake reforms in the Congress. And the courts, they betray their sworn oaths to the Constitution and Bill of Rights again and again, and can in no way be trusted to stop the abuses for us. We've got to do it ourselves. How? We nullify it at the state level. It's still not easy, but the OffNow project of the 10th Amendment Center has gotten off to a great start. I mean it. There's real reason to be optimistic here. They've gotten their model legislation introduced all over the place, in state after state. I've lost count, more than a dozen. You're always wondering, yeah, but what can we do? Here's something. Something important. Something that can work if we do the work. Get started cutting off the NSA support in your state. Go to offnow.org.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.LRN.fm. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit the Liberty Radio Network when you shop at Amazon via shop.lrn.fm.
If you enjoy lrn.fm, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
The latest edition of William Norman Griggs' Freedom Zealot podcast is next on the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
Now, shall we begin?